That's West Virginia native Landau Eugene Murphy on Veterans Day. Another important Saturday night in the Sun Belt, one of the country's beloved surprise stories. Georgia Southern, no longer a surprise, invades Huntington, West Virginia to take on a fired up Marshall team on a special day in the community here in Huntington. Critical game in the East Division standings in particular. Coastal just beat Texas State. Georgia Southern has a win over Coastal. They're trying to keep their opportunity alive to potentially make it to a conference championship. Remember, James Madison is ineligible this year for that conference championship game in the Sun Belt. As we welcome you inside here in Huntington, that's Tioka Jackson. I'm Jason Ross Jr. Another critical night in the Sun Belt, another fun night on NFL Network. Tioka, we saw those standings there. Big win for Georgia Southern. Still important games to be played as well for Marshall team trying to make a bowl game.
Yeah, look, the Eagles are in position to make a run at this Sun Belt East Side crown, and that's about all you can hope for this time of year. And if you're Marshall, look, you need two more wins to get the bowl eligibility for the seventh straight season. That's huge. This should be big for both teams.
Yeah, they've lost five in a row, but have won five in a row between these series. So we take a look at the Georgia Southern offense first. It's an offense with NASCAR-like wide receivers here.
Yeah, look, the guy on the left side of the screen, Cable Hood, is the most prolific receiver in Eagle football history. And this offense, there's only two offenses with two guys with 50 or more catches. The Washington Huskies are the other one. We know how explosive this is. They are, I should say. And look, this is the big time passing offense of the air raid. It's going to be on full display. And if you haven't seen it, it's going to be a lot of fun tonight.
So how do you stop it? Well, for Marshall, look at their corners, J.J. Roberts, Micah Abraham in particular, two of the best, not only in the conference, maybe the country. They got to be some of the best in the country today.
Well, look, if you like one-on-one matchups, guy versus guy, good versus good, mano y mano, you come to the right place, because the way Marshall plays defense, it's going to be tight, bumping one, man-to-man coverage for the majority of this game. And these two corners are as good as it gets in this conference, and like you said, maybe in America. But I will say this, a good defense is a good offense for Marshall tonight, because they need to run the football and keep it out of Georgia Southern's hands.
Charles Huff team playing for the 75 that were lost in the 1970 Marshall plane crash. And he says a part of the reason why we play for the 75, a part of that mentality is not quitting. They've lost five in a row, but they are not quitting on this season. It's an important game for them on this home field. Flip it over. Clay Helton has done a spectacular job at the helm for Georgia Southern as head coach of this program in just his second season. They could still potentially be on track for maybe a 10, potentially 11 win season if you think bowl game and conference championship. They're going to kick off to begin this one today. Michael Lance will have the duties back to return for Marshall, Jaden Harrison, and Ethan Payne. Under the bright lights, another big Saturday night in the Sun Belt. Off we go. Harrison returning here. Nice cutback from Harrison. This is the momentum they were looking for. Out of the gates, Jaden Harrison down the sideline. He's going to go.
Well, listen, Jason, I promise you, right in front of me are notes. They must. And number one, three-phase false start. Fast start. Offense, defense, and special teams, and there is the fast start of the special teams. And what you need from a great return is great block, and you got to make one guy miss minimal. He made two guys miss, and it's off to the races. And he doesn't lose many races. You can see running away from the coverage team. That's as fast a start as you could possibly hope for if you'd have heard.
First opening quarter touchdown for Marshall since October 7th against NC State. And they do it in the first 15 seconds of the opening quarter by way of this 98-yard return from Jaden Harrison.
Well, listen, we talked about how Marshall in the past has not started with the right energy. Well, give me energy and execution. That's execution. That is perfect blocking, and he's got to make one guy miss. You can't block them all. He did that to the sidelines, and baby, oh baby, the herd are off and running.
Could not have dreamt of a better start for Marshall on this night in particular. Jaden Harrison, electric out of the gates, and Marshall's on the board first. Something they haven't said recently, those smiles say a lot. They say more than we could possibly say for this team right now.
Well, they're the number one kick return team in the conference. So this is nothing new for what they do. So three phases I talked about, getting off to a fast start. The defense is coming up next, but this is one of the areas where Marshall takes a backseat to nobody in terms of his kicking units.
Well, quick start to this game.
You're awake now, aren't you?
You got to wake up for these two teams on a Saturday night. So DeAndre Buchanan back to return. Now Georgia Southern's opening possession will begin here after the Cobb return on the short kick. 20 seconds in, Georgia Southern finds themselves down 7, a team that has played in front a lot this year under Clay Helton. There's Davis Brin, the QB. They like to move it quickly, air raid, and fast.
What's funny is we talked to the offensive coordinator, Brian Ellis, and said, we call it pro raid. Everyone else calls it air raid. We call it pro raid. We are pro-style air raid offense. And it's all about Davis Brin's decision-making and accuracy. His superpower is his ability to put the ball where it needs to be and with pinpoint accuracy.
Some trickery on the opening play. Cobb is going to throw it downfield. Incomplete. Wide receiver Cobb there on the first pass attempt of the game. Intentions for Marcus Sanders.
Deonnie Hill. We talked about these two corners, right? In the open, Deonnie Hill, excellent job of eye discipline, staying with your man, plaster. And that's what the bump and run man-to-man coverage makes you do. You're going to follow your guy wherever he goes. He did a great job of that.
They brought McAfee in motion, flipped it out to the running back. It's White. His speed burst in that open field has been excellent this season for Georgia Southern. Picks up a first down there in the passing game. Brought down by Hill.
I love the call. That's what Brian Hill Ellis is saying. Okay, you're going to run man coverage? We're going to run man beaters. We're going to throw the football into the flat with big guys blocking little guys. And if you can get one or two guys blocked up, you can get a positive play. And that's what happened there.
First flag of the game over near the Marshall sideline. That's our referee, Scott Broadway. Penalty on Khalil Crowder.
A little bit of atmosphere out here, a little bit of crowd noise, right?
Mm-hmm. Marshall wearing their black uniforms today in honor of the 75. Georgia Southern 1-3 on the road this year, 5-0 at home.
Light box from Marshall. This should be a run.
It is. White will be dragged down in the backfield. Nice tackle there from Jacoby Henderson.
Well, what great support by Henderson coming up from his corner position. And when I talked about light box, you're going to see six guys in the box defensively for Marshall, and that means run. But when you're going to have guys playing this aggressive into the backfield, unblocked, little guys making big plays like that, still going to be tough to run against them.
Now 2nd and 17 for Georgia Southern. Now, typically in this position, Davis Brin finds his target. Derwin Burgess able to get a good chunk of that yardage back all the way up near the sticks. Looked like they picked up exactly 17, and it's a first down.
Well, Burgess is a guy that is the complement to Caleb Hood. And you see number 17, Daylon Cobb, getting up the field, running off the corner. And then behind that, Burgess runs was basically a bench route, an out route. And the ball comes on time and on target. Tough to defend this passing offense.
Into plus territory they go now under their veteran QB, Davis Brin. Played his first five seasons at Tulsa. Jalen White found a nice crease there. You see how he just slashes up those hashes. Charles Huff pointed out that this offense tends to get some favorable boxes defensively when it comes to approaches against that run game. He does the pass game, right?
That's exactly right. And this guy makes you pay when you want to go light boxes because he's got 4-5 speed and can find the holes.
Here's the quick miss. Throw is a bit low there. It's incomplete into the turf.
This offense of Georgia Southern loves to go fast, and they love to run up the amount of plays. That's how they wear you out defensively. They want to get up 65, 70, 75 plays a game and just make this a track meet and get this defense really breathing hard.
A.J. McGee was in on the coverage on that last play. He and the Marshall defense trying to lock in. Some talk up front. Marshall thinks this is a penalty against... They get Rasheed Miller up front.
Well, Miller moved and he tried to play it off and act like he was looking for an adjustment. And that's a nice try. Nice job of acting by Miller. But no, the guys in the striped shirts, they see exactly what's happening. And the Marshall defensive line helped them see it as well.
Marshall's been on the road the last couple of weeks. Both losses against Coastal Carolina and App State. Energy out of the gates hasn't matched what they brought today. This is a little different. And a timeout was just called. It's like by the Marshall sideline. Tioka, you did not like Marshall's energy a couple of weeks ago early on against Coastal Carolina. Scored single digits in that game. App State last week, a little better. But this week, out of the gates right now, a 98-yard kick return helps out.
Well, here's the thing. Give me execution over energy any day. I want both. I'm greedy. But give me execution over anything else. And so the energy is there. Obviously, that big kickoff return helps that energy stay that way. But this is going to be about four quarters of execution by the guys in the black jerseys. This matchup is primed for their profile of defense to win it, and even offensively, the way they run the football. The question is, will you have four quarters of execution and keep the Marshall beaters down? And we'll talk about that as the game goes on. This is one of the best third down offenses in America and one of the best third down defenses in America. So another snapshot of good against good in this game.
Bryn, well protected, climbs the pocket. And a crossing route immediately snuffed out. Caleb Hood caught it. But Deanna Hill came over to make the tackle. Brings up fourth down and medium here. And the special teams unit is coming out in the form of a punt here for Georgia Southern on their opening drive. Alex Smith, the Aussie, first Australian player in Georgia Southern program history, will punt it away here. And this special teams occasion goes a lot better than the first special teams occasion for Georgia Southern. A special day here in Huntington, West Virginia, honoring the 75 that were lost in the 1970 Marshall plane crash on Southern Airways Flight 932. Honoring those victims, the families, and this community today. The Thundering Herd taking on the Eagles of Georgia Southern.
Is it wrong when I look at that statue that I see a burger?
I don't know if it's necessarily wrong. It may be factual.
You see wings, don't you? But that's not a chicken, please.
There's Marco, one of the best mascots in the Sun Belt. And now Cole Pennington will make his first start of the season. May have had that ball deflected and it's intercepted on his first throw of the game. Intercepted by Tarion Lee, the deflection from behind. And now this sets up Georgia Southern in a prime position to tie the football game potentially.
OMG. You come in throwing out of your own end zone, trying to catch the defense slipping, and they catch your pass protection slipping. And I believe that was Big Latrell Bullard 6'1", 340, and that's a lie because he's more than 340, but shows his quickness. Look at that swim move. Just enough right there, big fella, to get a huge play to set up your already explosive offense inside the red zone. Wow.
We were just about to say, didn't have time to say, Cole Pennington was playing ahead with this lead, stepping in for Cam Fancher in the start. But now Georgia Southern trying to counter, and the Marshall defense, they got off to such an excellent start this season. They've struggled over the last few weeks. Eli Neal and company there, Deonte Hill involved as well. They've stepped up. They know they need to step up this week.
Yeah, they do. And we've seen this defense play great. If you go back to last year, this defense had put one of the best performances on film I saw all last year when they beat Notre Dame at Notre Dame. They've had some injuries, some communication problems in the back half. They were uncharacteristic, giving us some big plays early in the year. But this is a first-rate defense when they're right.
Bryn has vertical threats. Now Bryn steps up. Got some yardage there. To your point on Marshall, beginning of the season, 4-0 start. This was still a relatively inexperienced defense. They lost Stephen Gilmore, who began the preseason with the Detroit Lions. Excellent corner. They're getting reps now, and they're coming together. And it's late in the season.
They were very close to starting off 5-0. Lost a heartbreaker 41-48 at NC State, and they just haven't been able to recover.
Haven't won since that loss. They've lost 5 in a row. Davis Bryn in the loudest part of the stadium.
Tamar Marshall.
Seconds of the opening half for Marshall, really in the opening minutes of this first quarter. Didn't like what they saw there, so we'll talk things over.
This is the best red zone offense that the Sun Belt has to offer. So if you're going to be down here, you better be right, because they will exploit you. This offense is special.
Well, get ready for the Colts and Patriots tomorrow with NFL Game Day kickoff. Colleen Wolf leads our studio crew with Stacey Dales and Sarah Walsh, an all-star crew on the sidelines in Frankfurt tomorrow, 7 a.m. Eastern on NFL Network and streaming on NFL Plus. More international action in the NFL yet. Chiefs, Dolphins last week on NFL Network. Marshall and Georgia Southern tonight on Saturday night. College football here. Tyoka Jackson, Jason Ross Jr., Davis Bryn knocking on the door here. Another third down for this Georgia Southern offense. 0-for-1 so far.
12 personnel in the game. Two tight ends, one back. Two wide receivers.
They've had struggles in the red zone this season. They won't finish it off here. Coming from behind was Sam Burton, exploding off the edge.
Well, offensive coordinator Brian Ellis told us that these are the four best defensive ends that we'll face all year. And Burton is a backup. And look at that move on the outside. You put these guys on islands one-on-one, they will win. And with this coverage being so tight, see the indecision right there by Bryn? That's good team defense. Make them hold it, and the rush gets home. This is a great start defensively by Marshall.
38-yard attempts coming up here on the field goal attempts. Lance looks wide. So Marshall off to a start that feels much different than the last 5 weeks of football they've played. Georgia Southern, it's a critical game for them in the East Division standings, where they've taken a haymaker early on.
Big games.
Sam Burton and the Marshall defense able to stymie Georgia Southern. They come away with no points after setting up inside of the 20 off that Cole Pennington interception that he threw on just his first pass of the game. So all of a sudden now, the redshirt freshman quarterback, son of the Marshall great Chad Pennington, has to put that last throw, his only one of the game, in the rearview mirror. They'll try to get settled in with a Rasheen Ali run. The defensive line that Charles Huff called the best that Marshall has seen this season comes up big on their opening play.
Well, that's T.J. Smith getting up into the line. So that D-line, you saw a lot of quick penetration early, and then T.J. Smith came and cleaned it up. As you look at a little bit about Cole Pennington, played against his dad, obviously one of the great players ever in Marshall history. And Cole is just getting his career started here. He's learning on the job, and what an environment to come in and get your first start.
So Cam Fant, who started the weeks this season, didn't really practice this week, and apparently not ready to go today on game day. What a hit in the open field for Mark Stampley there. Able to undercut the tight end, Chris Montillo. Brings up third and long here.
So this is where we'll see how much this young quarterback has matured over the last couple weeks. This is not where Marshall wants to be, third and long. And so are they going to trust him to try to get this first down, or would this just be about managing the football and getting a good opportunity to punt it away?
Pressure came, had to dump it off and check it down. Incomplete. So a three and out forced by the Georgia Southern defense. It looks good. It's an undermanned Georgia Southern team today. No Damel Hickman at corner. He's out. Justin Myers out as well. But they don't look like they're missing a beat right now. But down seven.
And Cam Williams is out. So they got multiple guys that they count on in the secondary out. That's the bad news. The good news is they have an inexperienced quarterback on the other side who may not be to take advantage of it.
McConnell to punt. He's punted way too often for their liking the last few weeks. Good to return this. Made a man miss. And now a chance. Can he beat one more? Hit at the 20. And another possession will set up inside of the red zone for Georgia Southern after the Caleb Hood return there. An electric one.
Well, he's not just one of the best receivers in America. He's got the juice. Look at the quickness right there. And we talked about when returns, whether it's punt return or kickoff return, you usually have to make at least one guy miss. Well, I count it forward there. If that's not good enough for you, I don't know what is. But the type of quickness that he has in the open field, you'll see him play just like this in their base offense because they love to run smoke screens and tunnel screens to get him the football in the open space because he's dynamic.
If you tune in late, special teams has played a key role in this football game so far. Began with a bang, a 98-yard Marshall kickoff return for a touchdown. Jalen White trying to make men miss, but gobbled up eventually by Eli Neal. It was Jaden Henderson who had the 98-yard return on the opening kickoff return of the game. A Marshall team that hasn't scored a first-quarter touchdown since October 7th came out with that. A dream start, really. But the red zone offense for Georgia Southern, the story this season, it hasn't been as good as they would like, despite how many points they put up. Came away scoreless on that opening red zone opportunity. They want Burgess here, and it's broken up. Some excellent coverage from Deani Hill.
Well, they're going to pick on Hill because we know Micah Abraham is one of the best in America. But guess what? Hill can play himself as well. Look at him look back. That's the whole key, Jason. They were engaged. There was some contact there, but he looked back. That's the key to playing bump and run man-to-man coverage. You be in the player's hip of the receiver and look when he looks and go up and make a play on the ball. That's textbook right there by Hill.
How about an empty backfield now for Davis Brin? Third and 11. Struggles in the red zone. Will they continue? Brin heads Burgess crossing and found him. Burgess couldn't make Eli Neal miss along the sideline. And Marshall defense stands tall. The fans love it.
Well, Davis was a little late with the ball. I'd like to see him get that ball to Burgess a little earlier to give him opportunity to make a man miss and make a big play, at least get the first down. But because he held it so long, the sideline becomes a defender. And I'm going to tell you right now, Jason, there's one defender in the history of football that's never missed a tackle, and that's Sammy Sideline.
One of your favorite guys that you used to play with. Meanwhile, Michael Lance missed his first attempt from 38. Can he get this from 35? Ooh, it snuck inside. And Georgia Southern's on the board. What's been an eventful start to this football game began with a 98-yard kickoff return for Marshall. Georgia Southern trims the lead to 4.
Whoa, the new iPhone 15. But that amazing.
Now. Nightfall in Huntington, West Virginia. College football on NFL Network brings you back to Marshall University on a night where they're honoring the 75 lives lost in 1970 Marshall football plane crash. Charles Huff, the head coach for Marshall, said, "This is the most important game we play." That's why they're wearing the black uniforms today. You see the 75 on the sideline. There's a 75 decal on the back of the Georgia Southern helmets as well, as they collectively honor the families. You see Ethan Payne call for the fair catch there. Marshall's offense has come out. Defense as well have looked like this is the most important game of their season.
But there's no question. The energy is there. The passion is there. We all know what you're playing for. You just detail it. There it is on the screen. So I expect the energy to be there. I expected that before kickoff, but here's the deal. High energy is important, but it's not a substitute for execution. I don't want to be Debbie Downer. I'm just telling you, for four quarters, you got to execute, because there's no better way to honor that 75 than with a win at home.
Our director, Kevin Shanks, showing us some beautiful pictures there around the stadium. Now Cole Pennington comes back out, starting in place of an injured Cam Fancher. Rasheen Ali, who's been one of the best backs this season when healthy, he's been dinged up as much as this Marshall team. We're at that stage of the season where everyone's kind of battling through something. But good to have Rasheen Ali back in the backfield for Marshall. Picked up a couple there. This Georgia Southern team, again, 1-3 on the road this year. They have lost five straight to Marshall. You wonder how much that creeps in the heads of the Georgia Southern players. Throw over the middle, first completion, and it could be a big one. DeMarcus Harris off to the races, into the second level. DeMarcus Harris inside of the 15.
Transfer from Kentucky, and I want you to watch this ball from young Cole Pennington. Beautiful. That's how you hit a man with a slant, because you're hitting him in stride, and Harris does the rest for you. He is not going to go down easy. Terrific play by Harris.
Longest completion of the career for Cole Pennington so far. Now they're moving the pile inside of the five, and Georgia Southern has taken one on the chin in this opening quarter. An explosive start for Marshall. You said we need to find ways to maybe test an undermanned Georgia Southern defense. They did that here. That was a gain of 62 before the run.
And that's taking great, to your point, taking great advantage of Georgia Southern trying to stack the box to stop the established run game of Rasheen Ali. And so give credit to this herd coaching staff to say, hey, we believe in young Cole Pennington. We can throw slants over the middle against man coverage.
The Georgia Southern team that's coming off a 45-24 loss to Texas State.
Timeout. Georgia Southern. Their first. 30-second timeout.
Clay Helton just took a timeout. His group at 6-3 on the season, 3-2 in conference play. Coastal Carolina beat Texas State earlier today. That's important because they're both in the East Division with the James Madison team at the top that's ineligible to play in the conference championship. Georgia Southern has beaten Coastal Carolina, so they would have the tiebreaker there, trying to stay in contention. App State in the mix as well still, trying to stay in contention for a berth into the conference championship game. Clay Helton called this a must win, and his team is backed up here.
Well, it's time for the Georgia Southern defense to stand up. Right now, like you said, they've taken a couple hits. One of them they weren't even on the field for, the touchdown, obviously, on the kickoff return. But defensively, you're saying we can't let this offense with a backup young quarterback score touchdowns against us. We're going to force field goals, understanding that our offense, with the explosiveness, field goals won't get it done.
You mentioned food earlier, my friend. The popcorn smell is percolating here at Jones C. Edwards Stadium, and Marshall is putting on a good show for the popcorn eaters right now.
You know, when you bring up food, I get all discombobulated, man. Why would you do that to me? Now I got to refocus. Popcorn.
That's what I do for you, my friend. Marshall doesn't look discombobulated early on. They go to Rasheen Ali. He's their bread and butter, so to speak, on that popcorn. A flag goes flying.
Yeah, I think that was a hold on the edge.
Typically get that on those stretch runs down in this territory. Shamar Bartholomew over there, he's the one stepping in for DeMel Hickman today.
Holding. Offense number 51. 10-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Scott Broadway agrees with you calling that holding on Lloyd Willis.
Yeah, and Lloyd was, I believe, in as an extra offensive lineman. He's their backup right tackle. But either way, he's on the inline of the line of scrimmage. And when you run outside zone, the inline of the line of scrimmage, well, you're in the hot seat. You can't hold there. You got to keep your hands inside. Those hands get outside. It's an easy call for the officials.
So that pushes Marshall back here. Bendon hands it off again to Ali. A nice cut. And picked up about four there. Another early narrative in this football game. On the flip side, Georgia Southern has struggled in the red zone. They've been inside of the 20 twice and have only come away with three total points.
And they haven't been the most stringent run defense that you'll find. They give up nearly 150 yards a game, and that plays right into the hands of Marshall. And that last penalty was the first Marshall beater that we've seen today. So they're going to have to keep the Marshall beaters down just so they don't put that man in the middle of your screen, young Pennington, in bad situations. This was not a bad situation. Here you got to be smart. You're in field goal range. Don't force it. Take what the defense gives you.
Third and goal from the 8. They're going to try to take it with Ali, who hurdles inside of the 5. Will likely settle for the field goal attempt here. So a really good stand and a big moment for Georgia Southern after the penalty.
If you haven't seen Rasheen Ali play, you're in for a treat. This guy is dynamic. Beautiful, beautiful jump over the defender. You gotta be careful with that because other guys are coming, but nice job of ball security too. You see a lot of guys get hit in the air and that ball comes out. Not that time.
Reese Verhoff comes in to attempt a 22-yard chip shot to try to make this a touchdown game. Split the uprights. 10 first quarter points. More points than Marshall has scored over the last 3 weeks. And when it comes to individual games, single-digit performances each of the last 3 weeks. They put up 10 in the first quarter. It feels almost like a collective sigh of relief right now.
Yeah, they're hitting on all cylinders because they're even moving the ball offensively. The only thing I would say, though, is it's only 10 points. And we know that's not going to be nearly enough. Can they continue offensively to be efficient, get in the red zone, and score in the red zone? Really need touchdowns. Field goal's okay for right now, but going forward, that will not be enough.
The Georgia Southern team that has put up points this year, they've played ahead. Number one passing offense in the Sun Belt. Down 7 early here. Kickoff will be taken back by Buchanan. And he is driven down at the 25. Set your alarm. Tomorrow, Sunday Morning Football is back for an encore in Frankfurt, Germany, exclusively on NFL Network. Watch with the world as the Colts face off against the Patriots. Rise, shine, and watch tomorrow at 9:30 a.m. Eastern, only on NFL Network and streaming on NFL Plus. Have another excellent crew in Frankfurt for you, exclusively on NFL Network and NFL Plus tomorrow morning. Davis Brin comes back out. This offense that's been one of the best in the Sun Belt. Mentioned best passing offense in the Sun Belt. Probably lucky to be down just 7 here, but on the flip side of that, you could say maybe they should be up potentially given they only have 3 points and 2 red zone trips.
Officials time out to correct the chain, a broken chain.
All right, broken chain. Some chains to clean up.
Goodness, it's hard. You know, hey, listen, I don't know if you know this, but a chain is only as strong as its weakest link.
They need the chains that you wear to the games each day, each week. You got the, you have the good chains. You have the high quality chains. You could lend them one of your chains.
Let me just say to all the young fans watching, that's Cap. Jason is capping right now.
Stay tuned for our next on camera. And Davis Brin comes back out for his next appearance on camera. They'll hand it off here. The White ran into a wall. What do you like about this Marshall D-line early on?
Well, they are athletic. And in the interior of that D-line, they're big. You got 200-300-pounders with Legs and Thomas on the inside. And then on the outside, they go 4 deep with dynamic athletes. And Porter, Alston, Burton, and Green. They really get after the quarterback. The whole key is, can they be efficient stopping the run and force any offense in obvious passing situations? Because we talked about the corners and their ability to cover, and these guys up front can really get after the quarterback.
Bryn, quick throw off the hands of his intended target. Micah Abraham was over on the coverage there. Working against Anthony Quealy. You played with his dad.
I did. His dad was outstanding with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, played a long time, led the league in interceptions while we were together, and he's tutored his son very nicely. I think young Abraham will be playing in the National Football League just like his dad one day.
And he gave you some restaurant recommendations yesterday as well.
Yeah, he did, and I passed it along to the crew. You know, I'm about sharing, bro.
Sharing and caring. Third and nine coming up for Davis Bryn. Pressure up the middle, climbs the pocket. Late decision from the veteran to look for Quealy. Again, excellent coverage. Same story there with Abraham in on the coverage.
Well, this is what tight man coverage does for you. Watch Abraham. He does not look into the backfield until the very end of that route. And what you'd like to see is he's finishing physically with his hands at the catch point. I don't want defensive backs who aren't physical. I want guys that are going to be competitive and physical at the catch point and get that ball out. Nice job by Abraham.
What a job there. Just like you said, physically, the footwork without pass interference.
That's right.
Talik Keaton back to return. Going to call a fair catch here. Inside of the final 2 minutes of this opening quarter. See the drive chart for Marshall so far, and this not including a 98-yard kickoff return that began the game from Jaden Harrison for a touchdown.
Well, so this is the best starting offense that they've had for the game. They're at the 31, the minus 31. And so what I'd like to see them do is start to get established this running game. Your best offensive player is Rasheen Ali. He's also your best comfort blanket to a young quarterback. And we've seen what a slant will do to this defense when they're looking to stop this run.
Place Helton said he wanted 9 defensive drive stops in this game. Cole Pennington pressured here. You said just make the smart decision at times. That one was to just kind of submit to being wrapped up by Isaac Walker.
Yeah, you got to be careful. And I understand, look, if you're going to throw the football, why not early downs off play action? But the Georgia State defense was having none of it. The coverage was unbelievable. And you see, when he pulls that ball down, he's going to have multiple white jerseys in the backfield, and Walker is an elite pass rusher. He's somebody that young Pennington needs to be concerned about on every play.
Isaac Walker has 5 forced fumbles this season. That leads the FBS.
Most of America.
Ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
He attacks the football. When he tackles the quarterback, he's looking to get the ball out.
Interesting empty backfield here for the young Cole Pennington. Screen set up. And quickly being taken down was DeMarcus Harris. Out of the edge there to make the tackle is Terrion Lee, who had the interception on Cole Pennington's first pass of the game. Interceptions, turnovers, been an issue for Marshall in recent weeks during this 5-game losing streak after the 4-0 start. Charles Huff and company trying to clean that up. But in a third and long situation here, his offense not necessarily built for this.
No, and there's no way I'm testing this defense here. I'm looking to hand this football off and play field position, punting the ball away. And look, it's a light box and all that. It's set up for a run. There's no way I'm throwing into 8 guys covering.
Get some of it back. Set up the punt unit potentially. 2 good defensive lines going head-to-head in this football game. We had some points out of the gates, but there's a chance that these defenses could really settle in. Kadri Jackson made the tackle there and forced the 4th down.
I just think that's smart football. That's what you want from Clint Trickett. There's no need to try to do too much with a young quarterback and kill his confidence early.
End of an entertaining opening quarter. Marshall, Georgia Southern on a Saturday night in Huntington. Hard-hitting, explosive start. Marshall up 10-3 after 1. Clay Helton's team down 7. They're undefeated this season when forcing at least 3 turnovers. They forced 1 so far in this game. They're going to get a punt here, potentially receive it in favorable field position to return. Buchanan back to return this punt here from Verhoff. And Hood will return it. And Hood gets up to near the 50-yard line, 49. So field position flips in favor of Georgia Southern.
What a weapon this Hood is. Just get him the ball any way you can. Reverses, screens, downfield passes, punt returns. You just can't give him the ball enough because he is a house call waiting to happen.
Now out comes Davis Brin, an offensive line right now that you feel needs to step up on this possession.
Yeah, they need to take control of this game. Right now, they haven't been able to run it effectively. Every time Brin drops back, there's a guy in his face. This offensive line needs to step up and take control of that line of scrimmage so this offense can go.
Marshall corners have also been good. Some trickery opened up White. Jalen White galloping inside of the 30. Well, there's the offensive line and the deception initially. That also played a role.
Yeah, I love the execution. I love the call. Get yourself a little eye discipline problems defensively. But look at the blocking. Forget about the eye discipline. Look at the blocking. There isn't a defender that shows up until he's near the first down marker. And I'm just telling you right now, Jalen White is not the type of guy you want him running free in your secondary.
His last three games, each one has seen him run over 100 yards. Maybe one of the most underrated backs in the country right now. They go back to him. Hit on the interior there. Micah Abraham came up to make the tackle. Gibson in the mix as well. And it's a Georgia Southern team in the red zone so far that has had two opportunities inside of the 20. Only 3 points.
They got payoff on that field position they started with. The big play by White. We talked about how dynamic he is. He's a low 4'5 guy. 6 feet, 215. Kind of a taller guy. But, man, he runs with really impressive pad level when you watch him.
17 carries, 159 last week. Brin back to the air over the middle and caught. Up near the sticks, about a gain of 9 there. Able to connect with Caleb Hood.
It's so funny that once you get a couple runs, Jason, it's funny how that pass rush slows down a little bit. Gives your quarterback a little bit more time, and those throwing windows begin to open up for you. This is where the RPO offense of Georgia Southern is so tough to stop. They're going to count the box. No matter what was called in the huddle, they're going to count the box, and Brin's going to get him in the right play.
Third and two, shovel to White, and White got cut down short of the yard to gain. Eli Neal made the play. You can expect that from 24.
Yeah, that's the second time he's come up and made a big play. Watch him scrape to the outside and make a short tackle. Now, look, Neil, I want you to wrap your arms. That's the only thing that you can make go from an A-plus, or excuse me, from an A to an A-plus. Everything else was beautiful. Scraping, perfect angle, bring those arms, and that would have been a perfect tackle. But guess what? It's good enough as you see this Southern offense stay on the field on fourth down.
Fourth and two. First time Marshall's played in this home crowd in a few weeks, and they're trying to charge him up to get a fourth down stop.
His ball's going
to
come out quick and empty.
Flags went flying prior to the snap.
He snapped penalty. That's going to be the offense, no doubt.
Full start. Offense, number 75. 5-yard penalty. Very fourth down.
Can't afford this. When you're trying to win big games on a road, that type of stuff won't get it done. And look, I understand the crowds involved and the atmosphere, but this is about execution. These are moments. There are moments, Jason, in football games. You got about 8 to 10 of them. You got to take advantage of it. That was a missed opportunity by this Georgia Southern offense.
Sideline was not happy with that. And now a 39-yard attempt here. Lance has missed from 38 today. Another flag. This field goal attempt is good. We'll see what the flag is for.
This would be crazy if they give Georgia Southern the 5 yards right back.
And then potentially decision time.
That's right.
Fun game so far tonight here in Huntington. Big call from Scott Broadway here. So now, if you're Clay Helton, what do you do?
Well, listen, if fourth and one was good enough before, fourth and one and a half was good enough before, why wouldn't it be good enough again? And with that signal, I think that's some sort of either pulling and jumping over type deal.
Illegal formation. Defense number 98 lined up over the snapper at the snap. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Yeah, so that's a safety issue, and they made that rule a few years ago. You can't have somebody leaning or lining up over the snapper because he has his head down. Got to keep him healthy.
Georgia Southern's 8-for-11 on fourth down this season. They can reload here and try it again.
Now, interesting, Jason, the last time they were in this situation, they went empty. This time they got one back in the backfield, four wide receivers.
Brenda pass here. Over the middle, caught by Caleb Hood. First down, ninth fourth down conversion of the season for the Eagles, and that was a big one inside of the 10-yard line.
Well, I love the execution. You're going to see a receiver clear out this middle. Well, you want me to get it because they go so fast.
That's what they do for you. Davis Brin has to throw that away in the vicinity of White.
Second. But J.J. McCuffey cleared out the middle of that defense, and then you see a crosser coming from the outside. The whole thing was that offensive line gave Brin the time to decipher and find the open man later into that play.
Still a very hard 9 yards to go against this Marshall defensive line. It's Burgess in motion. Brin looks the opposite way, tried to dump it down low to McAfee, and that was batted out of the air. Gibson on the interior. The big tackle got his hand on that.
6'4", 312. And this is a smart call against an aggressive defense. Why not go screen? Well, you got to get the ball up over a 6'4" athlete. And Gibson just couldn't make it happen.
Still a lot of work to do to get these 9 yards. It's third and goal from the 9.
The good news is this is their offense. They're running base offense in this situation. They don't have to get out of character. The air raid is built for converting situations just like this.
Brin down the seam into the end zone. Was it caught? It is complete, and it is a Georgia Southern touchdown. Barden on the receiving end. Somehow Davis Brin squeezed it into a tight window.
You ever try to thread into a needle? It's really hard to do, especially you got fat fingers like me. Well, that's what you just saw right there. Boy, that was unbelievably tight. But Brin put just enough sauce on it to make it happen. It was a great catch by Barden.
Now a chance to tie the game. It feels like Georgia Southern has been on the field for a long time and finally produced the points to tie this game. They almost probably feel like they should be in front if you're a Georgia Southern fan. Right now, took a blow to the chin early in the form of a 98-yard kick return. But now, an opportunity to tie this after a gutsy fourth down conversion for Clay Helton's team. 10-10 game.
When you're an air raid offense, you don't have to be special. Just run your plays. And if you've got a quarterback like Davis Brin who throws darts, makes it all the better.
Baltimore Ravens. Stream Thursday Night Football only on Prime.
Davis Brin pretty amped up here on the sideline. Georgia Southern ties the game. They know how important this one is. Clay Helton called it a must-win game. When you take a peek at the East Division standings, they need this win. They really need to win out going up against the Coastal Carolina team that won today in those standings as Ethan Payne is tripped up with James Madison ineligible for the conference title. And a Marshall team trying to become bowl eligible. They're still a couple wins away from that, but they've done that 6 straight seasons. Cole Pennington on one side, Davis Brin on the other. Youth versus experience. 6th season for Davis Brin, 1st for Cole Pennington. How have the two fared so far?
Well, Pennington's been fine. I mean, that one interception is off of getting hit. And so, you know, he can erase that. Brin got off to a little bit of a slow start. The offensive line picked it up in that last drive, and he paid off very good starting field position. So right now, I would say everything's even. What, 10-10? Everything's even, but
Sheen Ali tackled on the edge there. Terrion Lee, who's had a big game, comes over to make the play.
Great job on a tunnel screen defensively, running to the football. That's what it's all about, rallying to the ball and making a tackle. But here's the point I'm making if I'm Georgia Southern defensively. I'm saying we've only given up 3 points, guys. So right now we're doing just fine. Forget about what the scoreboard says. We're playing dominant defensive football is what I'm telling myself. Now, on the other side, Marshall, we got to establish this run game. We got to protect our quarterback with this run game.
Here comes the run game that you want to see. Making the tackle there was Marquez Watson Trent.
And that first play, that tunnel screen is like a perimeter run. So they're doing the things to protect the young quarterback. That's just really good defense, both against the tunnel screen and the run game. Now it's setting up for third and longer than what Marshall wants. It's going to be very interesting to see this call. They're going to really try to pick up this first down again. It's just going to be about protecting the quarterback and make an easy underneath throw.
Eighth all-time meeting between these teams. Marshall has won 5 straight. A lot of new players on both sides, though, this season.
Eagles showing pressure. They bring it back in to pick it up.
Pressure came off the edges. Pennington picked it up well and then slipped it, and some balletic balance on the sideline there from Coombs. Did enough to pick up a first down.
Well, I like how they executed that play. Watch Coombs fake like he's going to block, and then boom, he's wide open because the rushers run right past him. So that's really good play call right there by Trickett, and the execution was high. And that's a nice job of staying disciplined and smart if you're Pennington and going all the way through that fake.
Ali patiently running over the herd logo. I'd like to see you, I just envision you balancing along the sideline like that, the tightrope.
And falling over. Big guys don't balance.
I never said
well.
I envisioned that. You envisioned that.
I'm good at tightroping around the corner, man, getting up to that quarterback. The quarterback's not involved. I'm not going to be very good at it.
Just a different pair of cleats is all. Second and 5 coming up here.
Nice job of first down running, staying ahead of schedule.
Ali looking for the edge. A nice burst before he's brought down by Marquez Watson Trent. The patience, the work behind this offensive line. Owen Porter challenged the rest of his guys earlier this week, and they're stepping up front.
Yeah, the patience and the vision, and there's a hat on a hat for a guy that can find it. That's a nice job of scraping over the top by Watson Trent, their leading tackler. He's probably the most valuable player defensively for these guys, Georgia Southern, just because he leads the team by a 2-1 margin of his closest teammate in terms of tackles on his way to 100.
Pennington to throw here. Run game setting up the passing game. Talik Keaton over the middle. Big gain in the plus territory. 15 more.
You talked about it. The run game setting up the pass game. Play action. You see him fake the stalk block like it was going to be a run, like he was going to go block the corner. Then he makes a nice move. Now, this is against zone coverage. And so right now, what you're trying to do is just throw through windows. If you're young Pennington, that's a nice job of seeing it and making a nice throw.
Now, here's back to that running game. They're running behind an offensive line that has looked good this week. Ethan Driscoll has spoken in the media over the last couple of weeks. The left tackle, Owen Porter, the Huntington native, and left guard actually spoke with the team about the meaning of this particular game, playing for the 75. He, of course, knows it better than a lot of guys being from Huntington. It's a group that stepped up, and this week, all the more important with a young QB making his first start of the season in Cole Pennington. They go back to the ground. Rasheen Ali running right behind Logan Osborne.
You see how the pile's falling forward every time Ali gets the football? That's the sign of a really good back. The really good backs, regardless of their size, they finish the run falling forward. That's extra yards. Over the course of 4 quarters, that's an extra 25, 30, 45 yards of rushing just falling forward for 2.5 or so a carry.
3rd and 3 now coming up here.
I think this is 4 down territory, Jason. That's how I would approach this.
Ali, the jump cut, got enough there to move the chains.
He's got excellent cutting ability, vision, and burst. So watch the cutting ability. Bam, back inside, and then he bursts off of it. It's hard to find guys who are both patient and then the ability to burst at a moment's notice. Ali's got the goods.
Do we get a whistle here? Sounds like a play clock issue.
Well, they want him to reset it. So that's interesting right there. Late substitutions.
Timeout. Marshall. Their third and final timeout of the half.
So when the offense substitutes late, Jason, the defense has to substitute, and that got late in the play clock. That's what forced that timeout.
Back in Huntington, starting to feel the festiveness around here, getting into the month of November, and deeper into November we go, the more important the games become. 10-10, this tie between Georgia Southern and Marshall here in Huntington. Inside of the final 6 minutes to go, Wildcat formation here out of the break. Right to Ali, now shovels it to McMillan. Has a block. Caleb McMillan wins the end zone, and he gives Marshall the lead.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, McMillan is the payoff guy, but watch the block on the outside. First of all, the offensive lineman doing great, looking for work. But there's the key block by his teammate. I'm trying to figure out who that was. I believe it might have been Daryl Simmons. But, man, that is unbelievable blocking and execution by this offense. There was not a defender to be seen in the screen. That's when you know you're getting it done from a blocking standpoint.
Marshall with 16 first half points, single digit performances each of the last 3 weeks offensively through four quarters. This week through a quarter and a half, they put up 17. That one, 10 plays, 74 yards, chewed up nearly 6 minutes of clock, and Caleb McMillan finishes it off with a 21 yard scamper into the end zone for the Thundering Herd.
Ladies and gentlemen.
...17-10, Marshall up. 5:32 to go in the second quarter. Don't think a lot of people had Marshall picked as having scored 17 points at this juncture of the football game. Caleb McMillan, the recipient of the last touchdown, 21 yards, took it to the house. And an excellent response to Georgia Southern tying the game at the time, 10-10. Now 5.5 to go. What will Clay Helton's team answer with? Take a look back at the last McMillan touchdown. Tioka, we talk about it. It's receiver blocks that usually lead to touchdowns.
That's right. And we also talked about energy being important, but execution being better. Look at the top of your screen. Look at them sell the go route. Now watch. Look at that. He's stopping down, and he's going to have to hold this block for a long time without getting a hold. Just watch the top of the screen just inside the 10. That is a coaching tape on how to block and get a pancake at the finish. Daryl Simmons, I tip my cap to you. That will not go in the stat sheet, but that's a big-time play by an unbelievably unselfish wide receiver, Daryl Simmons. I need receivers that are going to block. I mean, catching touchdowns are great. But what do you do for your teammates to win the game? Daryl Simmons just showed us.
We've known the talent has been there with this Marshall team over the last few weeks as Jaylen White cuts it upfield. It's been a matter of finishing. Right there, they finished defensively. Doing that more consistently, as Michael Green will be registered with the tackle there, has been the issue. They have finished today on both sides of the ball.
No question about it. And they're going to have to finish for all four quarters. Do not believe by any stretch of the imagination that the Eagles football team is going anywhere. You're going to have to knock them out the entire game in order to get this win.
An angry and motivated Georgia Southern team coming off a 21-point loss to Texas State. that hurt in the standings but didn't kill them by any means. They still control their own destiny. To continue to say that, though, they're going to need to win today. Oh, one-on-one matchup, one on the sideline there by Derwin Burgess. Going up against Deani Hill, and Burgess won the battle.
Well, we've seen this the entire game. They're going to go after Burgess. Great job of coming back for the football by number two, Derwin Burgess. It's so hard to defend against a back shoulder throw because you're worried about getting beat deep. The receiver has eyes on the football. You're late. He goes up and gets it. Excellent execution right there offensively.
Flags before the snap. Looks like this is going to go against Georgia Southern. So right after the big play.
Offense, number 60. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
They set themselves back.
Jason, it's so important against a bump and run man coverage defense like this to take your shots. You've got to force this defense to have some doubt in what they're doing philosophy-wise. They love to roll their corners up, put them on an island, and say, we don't believe you can get off the line of scrimmage and make big plays down the field. And that time, Burgess won the one-on-one battle, but it's going to be a ton more.
Number one passing offense in the Sun Belt, Berwyn. Look how calm he is in the pocket. Such a veteran, able to go to Caleb Hood there. Dragged out of bounds by Jacoby Henderson. Get some of that yardage back.
Well, you said he stood tall in his pocket, but watch the protection. They weren't getting this good of protection earlier. He's able to pump again, and then throw an accurate ball. But that takes offensive line stepping up and making it happen. We talked about that a couple drives ago, that they need to be better. They've gotten better, and now this offense is on the move.
Now you called for that not too long ago. Georgia Southern still with two timeouts. Marshall with no timeouts. Oh, the pump and down the seam wide open. Broken coverage on the back end. And Dalen Cobb made him pay for 47 yards.
Well, they've run that toss play a couple times, Jason. And that time they faked it. And I believe that was Jacoby Henderson who bit hook, line, and sinker. There's a safety up near the line of scrimmage, and that's a no-no. If you are in man coverage and you see the quarterback throw the football, you're going to see your man catching it. And that's an easy touchdown right there for the Eagles.
Michael Lance on to attempt the extra point. That's how quickly they can strike. Four plays, 75 yards, 7 points on the board. They're electric. That was a prime example of it.
The ball handling is beautiful, and the throw was even better. Don't miss the layup. Great job of hauling that in. Dalen Cobb, touchdown, Eagles.
This is the all-electric Pulse.
17-17 in the latest touchdown scored by number 17, Dalen Cobb.
This offense is like basketball, pace and space. They spread you out, they go quick, and they're basketball on the turf.
Would you say they're getting it down the floor pretty quickly? Keaton out of his own end zone takes a knee. 3:07 to go in the second quarter. We mentioned we got more football for you tomorrow on NFL Network, exclusively on NFL Network and NFL Plus. From Frankfurt, there's Travis Kelce wearing a Marshall Thundering Herd.
Wait, sure. Is Taylor here, you think?
I don't believe so.
I need a... Can we get on? I want an autograph, bro. Like,
it'd be pretty awesome if T. Swift could join us in the booth, potentially. Got to go to a Chiefs game, Tayoka.
Look at this. Look at the offensive difference tonight. That's unbelievable.
And you look at their first four games. They averaged 30 points per game. Last three, right there, 8 points per game. They've doubled that up in the opening half. And still have time here. 3:07. No timeouts, though. Got to stick with your bread and butter, as you've said. It's been the rushing game, getting established behind a motivated offensive line. And then they've let the young redshirt freshman unleash it a little bit.
Yeah, that's your blanket. That's your security blanket right there in Rasheed Ali. And they're so happy to have him back. You know, he's finally healthy. And defensive coordinator Brandon Bailey for Georgia Southern said this guy keeps him up at night. And you see why. The quickness, the elusiveness, and the burst.
Yeah. There it is. More patience, more burst, more first downs.
Slow to the hole. We talk about it every week. The big time backs are slow to the hole and fast through it. So watch him set up his blocks and look for the cutback right there. Boom, and it doesn't take. He's got staple gun quickness, like quick right now. See the hole, hit the hole.
Trying to set up a screen for Montgomery. They do. Chuck Montgomery gets out to the 43, and you're okay with them still being patient right now?
No question about it, because there's no need to get out of character and force your young quarterback to do things he's not comfortable with, because the other team will have the ball in a hurry. So forget about the clock right now. You just be meticulous in moving the football, understanding that every time we get a first down, you get an opportunity to get four more downs with the clock stopping momentarily at least.
Definitely an opportunity to still potentially take the lead going to halftime. Here's a first down. DeMarcus Harris going to look to get out of bounds here. That'll stop the clock momentarily. 93 seconds to go in the opening half.
So right now what you're seeing is a young quarterback in Cole Pennington getting comfortable. And he's leaning on his playmakers. He's staying within himself, not doing too much, taking what the defense gives him, but also allowing his playmakers to make it happen with the ball in their hands in space.
Cole Pennington starting today in place of Cam Fancher, who didn't practice much this week. We were told didn't dress. And the redshirt freshman, whose dad Chad Pennington played for Marshall, getting his first start, steps up here. He's thrown one interception today. We'll see what this is ruled. Right now, looks like it could be a fumble recovered by Georgia Southern.
And guess who, Jason? Isaac Walker again.
His sixth forced fumble of the season. That leads the FBS. New game, same story.
If you allow, covered by the defense, first down, Georgia Southern.
If you allow Isaac Walker to go one-on-one against your offensive line, you're taking your offensive life in your hands. Because not only will he get to the quarterback, we talked about he's going to be physical and get the ball out. The easiest man on the football field to make fumble is the quarterback. Isaac Walker understands that. Watch him attack the football. Well, that's how you do it. And excuse me, wait a minute. He gets the recovery, but that's Deshaun Davis attacking the football.
The field is a fumble recovered by the defense. The previous play is under video review.
So Deshaun Davis jars it loose. Isaac Walker comes up with it. And Georgia Southern, with two timeouts, could be set up now, flip the script, in prime position to take the lead.
Yeah, now the question is, was his arm going forward? And it looked very close to be just that. And remember, the call on the field is important. The call on the field is a fumble. So that means the footage that we're watching has to be conclusive that the call on the field was incorrect. I'm not sure if we're there yet. And I apologize for Deshaun, getting Deshaun mixed up with Walker, but he did a Walker impression. I mean, he attacked that football. Let's watch, though, to see if this arm is coming forward in the slightest. You know what, Jason? It appears to me that it starts forward, and that's all it takes. If he is in possession of this football and that ball begins to start forward, this is an incomplete pass.
After video review, the ruling on the field stands. First down, Georgia Southern.
Oh, that was close.
It was close.
It was so close, but, I'm okay with it. I'm not going to pick at that call.
And the initial call on the field feels right to keep it that way.
Yeah. I mean, look, it has to be conclusive evidence, and that's iffy on if that was conclusive evidence. So I'm always in favor of letting the athletes decide big plays like that on the field.
So here's this theme for Georgia Southern of hunting down that three turnover number they've loved this season. And all six wins, they forced at least three turnovers. They forced two in this opening half. You've mentioned that in losses, third quarter has been shaky. Coaches talk about the middle eight. All of a sudden, final 4 minutes of the opening half, final first 4 minutes of the second half has flipped in favor of this Georgia Southern team as they go over the middle, finding Caleb Hood here for a first down gain. And now you're all of a sudden quickly in field goal range with a minute to go.
Well, listen, you know they're going to be aggressive. This is the air raid offense. They're going to try to get points before the end. And I'm talking about the big points, the 6 points.
And Rin steps up, another confident throw, another one to Derwin Burgess. Tracked down by J.J. Roberts, who returned last week. 40 seconds to go in the opening half now.
Rin's doing a good job of getting back and getting his ball out of his hands. He does a great job at that moment normally. He will get back.
Georgia Southern, their second.
And get the ball out of his hands.
To 42 seconds. 42 seconds on the game.
To keep the offense out of sackable situations. And that's really important for quarterbacks not to hold the ball too long and then give up sacks. And in this situation, it's going to be critical because this team is driving. He understands that he at least should come away with 3 points. The ball's got to come out on time.
Don't forget, coming up at the half, NFL Fantasy Live is back in Total Access at the half as a preview of this week's top NFL games. Been a fun atmosphere here in Huntington tonight. 17-17. Marshall still playing for bowl eligibility. They want that for a seventh year in a row. New starting quarterback today. And Davis Brin for Georgia Southern after the turnover, trying to capitalize in an ultra-important game in the East Division standings for Georgia Southern, trying to keep their hopes of making the conference championship game alive after Coastal Carolina won earlier today. And James Madison ineligible for that conference title game. Davis Brin, veteran QB, finds Hood again, right at the sticks, enough for a first down.
And again, the ball coming out on time. So important in this air raid offense.
33 seconds, clock moving again, under the final 2 minutes. Davis Brin, that ball broken up, incomplete. Micah Abraham on the coverage there, and intentions for Jalen Barden.
Got to be very careful testing number 6 now. His ability to be tight at all times and attack the football, there aren't many guys that do it as well.
So you know you're at bare minimum in Michael Lance's field goal range, but still 27 seconds to go and a timeout to use.
They're trying to score a touchdown.
They had a quick 47-yard strike on their last possession that resulted in a touchdown. They don't have to go that far this time. One-on-one to the end zone. The outstretched arms of Jalen Barden couldn't catch up to that.
So much of playing cornerback specifically is about being in position. You can't defend everything, but if you keep your body in position, you're going to force perfect execution and just couldn't make it happen right there. You're in a trail technique, you don't grab, force a perfect throw and catch, and generally you're going to be fine.
J.J. Roberts, the Wake Forest transfer, on the coverage there, and now this defense, led by him and others, trying to get a big stop here and force the field goal.
Watch the pass rush from the Thundering Herd. Can they force this ball to come out quick and underneath?
Brin, empty backfield. Pocket movement, now he's out of the pocket, and it's incomplete. Deani Hill on the coverage against Sanders, and they're going to force the field goal.
You just can't overestimate the importance of pressure. And that time is Isaiah Gibson Sr. again showing up big. They run a pass rush game and watch Gibson coming outside. And Brent is unable to set his feet. And when a quarterback can't set his feet, it's a high chance it's going to be incomplete.
Now they break out the Jaws music here, building up the tension to this all-crucial field goal, 38-yard attempt for Lance at the end of the half. And he's able to get it to go to give Georgia Southern the lead. Another lead change in this back-and-forth football game. Well, 12 seconds. Jaden Henderson has already struck once on a kickoff return. This thing not over yet in this opening half. Wouldn't recommend going to look for your snacks just yet.
And I wouldn't recommend kicking it all deep.
Yep.
I would do some sort of squib or mortar kick just to take the ability for the big play and the special teams to happen to you again.
Charles Huff has to love how his team has performed in this opening half.
No question about it. We talked about the emotion. We knew it was going to be there. The emotion's been high. Check. The execution's been high. Check. Three-point game. We'll take that going into the locker room at home. This has played out exactly or near exactly the way the Herd wanted to. They got a chance now to take this ball game into the fourth quarter.
his mentality, the message, the guys like Jaden Henderson from Charles Huff has been, give yourself that opportunity. Give yourself opportunity by opportunity. They've certainly done that. And that's why we have a fun one tonight here in Huntington. And they won't give Harrison an opportunity here to your advice.
Yeah, that's smart. There's no need to be egotistical. We saw what happened in the opening kickoff. We're trying to win. All right? Discretion is the better part of valor.
Ooh.
Yeah, just kick it up, man. Let's go into the locker room with a three-point lead.
You're quite poetic tonight.
You think? Not Maya Angelou level poetic, but...
Was it the lobster and steak you had last night,
man,
that motivated you? I see your eyes when I brought that up.
Make me lose focus again. Bring the food.
Motivation between the lines on these sides today has been palpable. Cole Pennington content to knee it. Excellent first half of football here in Huntington. Georgia Southern will receive the second half kick, and they take the lead to end the opening half. So they'll have a chance to capitalize on the middle eight of the football game. They weren't good in the third quarter last week against Texas State. Going to the break and to the locker room here, it should be a very interesting second half of action.
If you're Georgia Southern, you're thinking, okay, the kickoff return, that's the difference in the ballgame. We'd be up by 10 if it weren't for that. If we don't screw it up on special teams, we'll win this game on the road. And if you're Marshall, you're saying, we got them, boys. We got them where we want them. And now we're going into the quarter where they lose a lot during the season. Let's take control of this football game in the third and win it in the fourth.
Well, more coming up at the half here on NFL Network. It's a three-point game at the break. Saturday night college football on NFL Network. Welcoming you back to Huntington, West Virginia. Marshall Thunder and Herd trailing by three after opening up the game with a 98-yard bang in the form of a kickoff return touchdown. From Jaden Henderson, Georgia Southern answered back as we expected and getting what we anticipated in a crucial week of the season for both teams. Really hard-fought battle on both sides. Taoka Jackson, Jason Ross Jr., happy to have you with us tonight. Well, these receivers for Georgia Southern, Taoka, we talked about it in the open. Not surprisingly, we find ourselves talking about it again at halftime.
How about that? Doesn't it feel good to talk about guys that get the ball in the game? And it doesn't get any better than that. But that's what this air raid offense is predicated on. Getting the football to their playmakers. And they don't throw the ball deep a ton. Everything's underneath, and it's about timing and execution of route combinations. But what I love is you don't see a bunch of drops. If you get the ball near Hood, he's going to catch outside of his body. You don't see a lot of body catching. It's about the hands. That's how you teach it. He's a guy you can rely on. But again, only one explosive play. That was the deep shot for the touchdown to Cobb, and that was because of blown coverage. The coverage of Marshall has been fairly good, and the execution by the Eagles has been good as well.
The energy and the passion that the defense of Marshall has played with, it's looked simply different than the last 5 weeks where they've lost those games. Micah Abraham and J.J. Roberts playing a key role in that, matching up against those top receivers for Georgia Southern today.
This is like a heavyweight fight. You're going to have to keep answering the bell. They're going to keep trying both of those corners that was on your screen. So they have to be here for four quarters. One thing to keep in mind, Marshall was -2 in a turnover ratio in that first half. That can't continue. And a developing situation with Georgia Southern. They ran 34 plays. 23 of them were in Marshall territory. That can't continue for the Herd to get this win.
For Georgia Southern, Buchanan brings this out to the 30. The Eagles had a field goal to take the lead at the tail end of the opening half. Now they get the ball to begin the second half. Davis Brin, second quarter, after the team settled in, offense looked much more fluid. They looked like Georgia Southern.
And he's looked like Davis Brin, the same guy you see on tape. When you watch him on tape, the ball's coming out on time. It's accurate. And the only thing about him is every now and then he'll throw an interception that you have to scratch your head about. Hasn't happened yet. Marshall's going to have to force some turnovers, I believe, in order to get this win at home.
Right now, Georgia Southern's up +2 in that turnover battle. 3 has been their magic number in all 6 wins this season. Throw it out to the flats, settling in with the tight end, Keaton Upshaw. who is driven to the ground out on the perimeter. A.J. McGee came over to make the tackle there.
So when you draw it up on the whiteboard, you say, we're going to run this screen. We're going to get our athlete out in space, and we're going to force a missed tackle and keep running. Well, that's all fine and good, but if you got a defender like McGee who's going to execute the fundamentals of tackling old school style, you're going to line up with second and long.
Maybe the first deep shot, it won't be, of this second half, as the coverage downfield was good. Porter came around the edge. They're blowing the play dead here. Third and eight coming up here for Georgia Southern.
Well, here's the leading sack, man.
There's no foul for intentional grounding. There was a receiver in the area.
Here's the leading sack man for Marshall's defense. Remember we talked about how quickly the ball comes out? Well, watch him hold it a little bit. That's the coverage. And then, boom, the rush pays off. That's easily an incomplete pass. But that's the way you tie in coverage and rush. Rush and coverage. That's the recipe for big-time defensive football.
The defensive end, Owen Porter, talked to this team earlier this week about how important this moment is.
Man coverage on the outside.
Davis Brin over the middle. He likes to squeeze it into those tight windows. Found Burgess. Is it enough for a first down? It will be right at the sticks. We'll see if they move it. I think they are. Now they will.
Well, this is an elite route right there. You see him stick his foot in the ground. You don't see any loss of speed from Burgess. So that way the defender has no idea where he's going, sticks his foot in the ground, and cuts sharp across the middle. And he's only open for a second, but that's all Davis Brin needs is just a second.
Feels like a save-the-season type of game for Marshall, and Owen Porter in this defense. Looks like they got a jump offside there on the Georgia Southern side.
False start. Offense, number 60, 5-yard penalty, first down.
And Georgia Southern on the flip side trying to stay in contention for a berth in the conference championship game, potentially trying to control their own destiny. Coastal Carolina beat Texas State earlier today in the East Division standings. Georgia Southern has the tiebreaker over Coastal Carolina if it were to come down to that. James Madison at the top, undefeated but ineligible for the conference title game this year. Jalen White wrapped up by Eli Neal.
Boy, this Eli Neal is impressive. He continues to have great eye discipline. See the ball and get ball. That's what you want from a linebacker. And you notice when he gets his hands on you, the play is over. Not a lot of missed tackles from number 24, Eli Neal.
He at one point in his career had a streak of 42 straight starts. Eli Neal at the heart of this defense. Second and long here. And Marshall's D trying to keep it that way. This is caught by Dalen Cobb. More flags, though. More whistles.
They're blowing it dead, so that's a dead ball foul, usually against the offense. Unless there's a substitution situation by the defense.
Delay of game. Defense, number 18, disconcerting signals at the snap. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Well,
illegal deception.
Yeah. And so what they're saying is he's making some calls to simulate the snap, talking about A.G. Mudgy, or excuse me, McGee. He's making some signals to simulate the snap, trying to get the offense to jump off, and got caught that time with his hands in the cookie jar. And that's a big play because they had second and long.
Georgia Southern get that yardage back. We'll see what they can do with it. Down the seam again. Excellent job in coverage to get back there from Jacoby Henderson working against Dalen Cobb.
Well, you called it. Excellent coverage. This time he's got outside leverage. And Cobb gets inside of him on the post route. The ball's a little off target. He should lead Cobb a little bit further inside. He throws it slightly behind, and that allows Henderson to come in and make a play on the ball, and make a play on the ball he did.
Third and 11 now.
What does Georgia Southern decide to do from a protection standpoint to give Brin time?
flag caught over the middle. Jalen Barden.
He's thrown in the area of offsides, Jason. Did someone line up in the neutral zone?
Officials
illegal formation. More than four players in the formation at the snap. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
And they were talking to Charles Huff down to the near sideline. And it is against Georgia Southern as they get set back again here. Clay Helton, the head coach for Georgia Southern, has done such a spectacular job in a short time building up what has truly been a magical season for the Eagles. A fan base that set a program record in attendance at Paulson Stadium.
Will be declined. It's going to be fourth down.
So, Jason, I was going to wonder, why would you accept that penalty? I mean, because you're off the field. So I was just waiting for you to be done with your point so I could make that point. But officials and Hurd get on the same page, because there's no way you accept that penalty and give this offense, this air raid offense, an opportunity to pick up a third down, because third and long is nothing for them.
And that brings out Talik Keaton in the punt return unit. Back to return this boot from Alex Smith. One of a few Aussie punters in the Sun Belt. This takes a bit of a Marshall bounce. So Marshall down three, Cole Pennington's first series of the second half when we return. Cool place to walk around, especially on the day of a football game. Sun Belt atmospheres and towns each have their own unique individual feel to them. We've had a fun time touring around the league this year, getting into the latter stages of the season. A couple of weeks to go. Georgia Southern has their senior day next week against Old Dominion before they close out the season against App State. Each game on the schedule very crucial for Georgia Southern in the conference standings. Marquez Watson Trent will probably get half a tackle there. He is two away from 100. Tarion Lee made the tackle as well, combining with him. For this Marshall team, a bowl is still potentially in sight. And this night means so much for them, honoring the 75. Charles Huff called it the most important game they play. And they have come out with the energy and passion as if they really heard him preaching that throughout the week.
Coach Huff also talked about making this scoreboard so close that it continues to allow Rasheen Ali to make an impact on this game, and that's what's happening here.
Right on cue, there's Rasheen Ali. A guy who took a medical redshirt last year after he dealt with injuries, burst onto the scene to begin this year, then got dinged up. He's starting to return back to health and practicing consistently. He's looking like the normal Rasheen Ali. They might give it to him here on third and two.
Why not? I mean, you can't give it to your best offensive player enough. And this offensive line has really gotten lathered up from maybe the second drive of the first quarter all the way until now.
They do give it to Ali, met by a wall of white jerseys, and looks like he's going to be short.
Well, that wall was led by number 88, Justin Rhodes. And at 6'2", 280, that's a wall you don't want to test. Boom! But he'll turn you around, get your headache in a hurry, and he's got friends coming with him. That's a great job on third and short.
There's a really good interior duo there between Rhodes and Latrell Bullard. Got some big guys. Tarion Lee trying to fire up his team on the sideline in this important game. And now an opportunity here for Cobb. Gets up the sideline. So 20-17, Georgia Southern leads it. Take a peek at the bowl-eligible teams in the Sun Belt right now. Marshall in the hunt there, four wins. Georgia Southern is bowl-eligible, but they have aspirations beyond just that. They want to make a conference title, potentially win a bowl game as well. They could be looking at a double-digit win season if they do both of those things. App State, Arkansas State, and Louisiana all knocking on the door as to as well.
And what that graphic says to me is, look at the depth of the Sun Belt Conference, though. I mean, just so much talent and so many great college football teams. And they do well out of conference as well. And we got a couple teams that beaten some Power Fives. I mean, this conference is really top to bottom, I think, the best group of five conference in America.
again, breaking through traffic, and both teams have tried to establish the run game, which has led to the passing game. I think the wins over Power 5 teams would back up what you said about this conference being perhaps the best group of five conference. They have consistently beaten Power 5 teams over the years. Georgia Southern led early in the second half at Wisconsin earlier this year. That was a motivating game for them. They felt maybe there was a little too much emotion. Bounced back the following win with a big win over Coastal Carolina. And they go to the sideline here. Burgess tried to stay in bounds, but wrestled down by Deani Hill. These Marshall corners haven't missed tackles tonight.
That's the key to this offense. Breaking tackles. The ball doesn't go deep for a lot of air yards. It's about timing and getting their athletes in space, which is placing a premium on not missing tackles, and the herd has been up to the task.
Davis Brin, not really known for his running ability, tried to squeak through for a first down. I think he, with that extra lunge, he got enough, and he did.
Yeah, it was a spin and a lunge. He showed me something right there that you don't see on tape from this guy a lot. It's a great job by Brin, spinning and turning and knowing exactly where the marker is for the first down to keep this drive going.
But Davis Brin said maybe this year more than any other in his career, he's been so dedicated in the film room. He came in motion to block for White, and White utilized that block to pick up 11 on first and 10.
He came into this game talking about White averaging 6.1 a carry, and this is how he does it. He sees a lot of light boxes, so once you get through the initial line, there's room to run, and watch the elusiveness. Very rarely does the first guy tackle number 25, White.
The block from McAfee as well on Steven Dix.
Did you see the tenaciousness? He never went down.
Like
that.
Some screens set up here. Room to roam. And knocking on the red zone door once again are the Eagles after the catch from Cobb.
So much of football, even in today's era where there's a lot of basketball on grass, is about attrition. And the play count is starting to rise for this Marshall defense. And you're starting to see some guys in black jerseys get a little tired. And this is when really Georgia Southern puts their foot on the gas and bury people.
Player down for Marshall here. It's Jacoby Henderson, who's had a really good night, along with the really that entire core of DBs for Marshall. Jacoby Henderson, redshirted last season, a redshirt freshman. Started the season rotating in, and now he's taken on a bigger and bigger role as the season has gone on. Good to see him get up on his own weight there. One of the younger players on this roster mentioned them playing for the 75 tonight. Head coach Charles Suff shows not only the freshmen, but all the newcomers on the roster, the movie We Are Marshall, before the season to understand the importance of this week on the field, off the field, in the community. Charles Suff said the longer he's been here, the more he's truly felt it when you meet people around the community who, of course, have ties to those who were involved in the plane crash. And this week means so much to everyone around here. Georgia Southern also taking part in collectively supporting the community, wearing the 75 decals in the back of their helmets. 7:12 to go in the third quarter. Georgia Southern wants to extend this lead. Brin, no flags. More good coverage from this Marshall secondary.
So defensive coordinator Jason Seymour is switching up a little bit. That was zone coverage. They decided to go with cover two there. Usually get a lot of man coverage from this Marshall defense, but that's cover two. They run a man beater route. That's just really good execution from the back half. Doing a good job of just, in that situation, confusing Brent.
It's Hood in motion this time. He'll fake it one way, going down the seam again for Hood. So all that deception was kind of revolved around Hood, but the connection wasn't there.
Usually you see Hood go down and dig that ball out. Not that I'm blaming him for not coming up to reception, but
it looked like Davis Brin was a bit frustrated with himself after that throw.
Yeah, because he pulled the string on it a little bit. You had a guy, you want to go ahead and get it there. So right now, If I'm Marshall, I got to heat up this pocket. I'd rather do it without blitzing, though.
Bren, one-on-one, Abraham covering. And that is incomplete. What a job from Micah Abraham, on Barden there.
Well, Barden's a dynamic player. He's a transfer from Pitt, and they like his athleticism. But again, look at the position of Abraham. Forcing perfection in the throw and catch. Almost, Braden almost comes with it. The placement of the ball was terrific. But Braden just couldn't contort his body and make the catch and stay in bounds all at the same time. And that's the position of Abraham forcing a tough throw.
Used your old friend Sammy Sideline for some help as well there. I'm catching on. Lance, 40-yard attempt. Six-point game. So Georgia Southern doesn't get six. They get three. Marshall defense keeps it a one-possession game. Their offense up next. There's Donnie Marshall, dad of Mike. Sorry, Donnie Abraham, dad of Micah Abraham.
Yeah, he was a great player. And he talked about, you know, what his son does well. And he says that Micah understands he has to find the football. I mean, so much of coverage is being where you need to be, playing the man, but you got to play the ball. And that's what he told him since he was a young kid. It's about the ball. Go attack the ball. And that's why you see a lot of incompletions when they throw at number six.
Well, salute to service is the year-round effort by the NFL and its military partners to honor, empower, and connect with our nation's service members, veterans, and their families at each time of the year. The NFL reinforces our support and gratitude to those who have served and to those who continue to serve. Visit NFL.com/salute to learn about the NFL's impact with its salute to service partners.
So right now, Jason, you feel like, as you see the little bit of chicanery with the shift and the Wildcat formation.
Rasheen Ali bounced it off the edge. Got out to the 45. There is a flag down behind the play.
This would be a horrible time for a Marshall beater. Looks like it's against Marshall, and you saw Ali's response. See, he's not happy about it, as he shouldn't be.
Holding. Offense number 68, 10-yard penalty, remains first down.
Jason, this feels like one of these moments where Marshall can't afford to have another drive come up empty. Right now, they're still obviously in connection. It's a one-score game, but you're going to have to change the scoreboard one way or another. You can't allow your offense to keep going out, coming up empty, and then their defense having all these plays pile up against them. They're going to wear out eventually if you keep letting that happen.
Cole Pennington. His throw connects. Able to find DeMarcus Harris, who had the big catch and run earlier in the game.
Pennington's a better player than he was a couple weeks ago when the first time I saw him. I mean, that is an excellent throw right there, on time, throwing with some conviction. He's got something to work with, this young quarterback. That penalty really got him off schedule. Let's see if he can get back in front of the sticks.
Pennington starting in place of Fancher today. Goes over the middle. Strong catch from DeMarcus Harris and a strong stiff arm. It's a foot race now. A stretch for the end zone. They're going to mark him down at the 5. Gain of 65.
So when you have a back like Rasheen Ali, it forces defenses to line up to take away the run. That creates one-on-one opportunities on the outside. You get one missed tackle, two missed tackles, and it's nearly a house call. Credit Georgia Southern for hustling on defense and not giving up on the play.
The Georgia Southern player down in the field here.
And the crowd should not be booing. I don't care about that. I mean, you can't be booing in that situation. You got a player down. Can't assume he's faking now.
appears to be Seth Robertson, who's down for Georgia Southern. There's Coach Huff, who is pretty animated there with the officials. We'll see what happened on this last sequence.
So they're trying to go fast. Now, maybe I spoke too soon.
Fans may have caught something there.
We still don't know 100% that nothing happened. Yeah. But, okay, I get it. Initially, everything was fine. And all of a sudden, something happened. And there's the, that's the right call by the official. You saw that left foot clearly out of bounds. But again, the hustle now, think about that. Let's keep a star on that play. The hustle by the Georgia Southern defense. Can they pay it off now by forcing a field goal? So you see Seth Roberts looking like he's having a calf issue, but the home crowd isn't buying it.
Well, Cole Pennington trying to capitalize here. He's 11 of 13, 185 yards in this game. Couple of explosives. They could potentially take the lead. Pennington keeps the play alive, then stretches for the end zone. The effort from the redshirt freshman leads to this game being tied.
How about the effort by the young quarterback? I love the decision by not trying to force this. Forcing the missed tackle. Now watch him lay out and reach that ball. Now the question is, did he step out of bounds? Great job of breaking tackle. Watch the right foot. See, to me, Jason, looked like he stepped out of bounds just before that ball crossed the goal line. Watch the right foot.
The field is a touchdown. The previous play
right there.
Video review.
Now, that look doesn't tell us where the ball is. So the call on the field was a touchdown. It has to be evidence that's irrefutable that says the call on the field is incorrect. Now, I believe right there that ball is short of the goal line. And I think that look right there tells us that it is short of the goal line, because you see that foot is out of bounds. Right there, it's touching white. What a great job by the guys in the truck to give us that look. I think that ball is going to be at the 1.5-yard line, partner. Right foot clearly out of bounds, but you can't see the ball from that look. So then you match that look with the sideline look, and I think that is conclusive. One more click, and there it is.
This should be a really good look here.
Yeah, so I think it may even be back to almost the 2-yard line. So I was going to say, but that hustle didn't get paid off, but right now, I don't think that's going to be a touchdown. So that hustle play by the Georgia Southern defense still might pay off.
Video review, the runner's foot was out of bounds prior to touching the goal line, the pile line. It'll be second down at the 1.5-yard line.
Well, Scott Broadway reverses the verdict, and now Charles Huff's team will have to try again to get in.
Well, look, I don't think you do anything complicated here. I think you bring your big personnel in the ball game. Tell your young quarterback to turn and hand the ball off to Rasheen Ali. And let your best offensive player get it done on second down, third down if needed, and fourth down as needed.
Pennington comes back out with the offense. 5:22 to go in the third quarter. And a chance to potentially tie and take the lead if they can get in the end zone.
11 personnel in the game. This is not big personnel. One tight end, one back, 3 wide receivers.
A Marshall team that's lost 5 in a row. Big possession here. And big bodies up front trying to move the way and break the goal line. They did. What a game it's been. Right from the start.
Now, Jason Ali is just over 200 pounds. He's not the biggest back, but watch the leg drive on contact. There's the first tackler. There's the second one. Who else wants to take a ride? The legs are still driving. That's great determination and a nose for the goal line. Here's another look. They've got him stopped, but he's determined. And it was interesting. There it is right there. See, that ball, I was going to say, was interesting. I never saw the ball cross, but it crossed right at the end. Great job by the officials.
So Reese Verhoff, Taoka can come on and give Marshall the lead here.
And that's what we talked about, Jason. We said that was a critical drive for Marshall.
Two possessions in this third quarter, couple of lead changes. Marshall is back on top here in Huntington.
So how would you describe the chicken to someone who had never tasted it?
Literally melt in your mouth tender. We don't have a freezer.
One-point Marshall lead, 5:06 to go in this third quarter. We are Marshall chants breaking out. And a good game broke out right from the start of it when Jaden Henderson returned a 98-yard kick return for a touchdown to get the scoring rolling. Since then, two ties, two lead changes, 1 point separating these teams in a very important matchup for the Pro Bowl games presented by Verizon. They're taking over Orlando. Be there live on February 4th for skills competitions. NFL flag football finale at Camping World Stadium. Tickets are on sale now. It's star-studded AFC versus NFC. Go to probowl.com/tickets to get yours today. Davis Brin takes back over. Georgia Southern starts it off with a dish to the running back, White, who's dragged down, maybe a horse collar, potentially face mask here on Josh Moten.
Yeah, I think you called it. I think he got a hold of that face mask. Long discussion. Makes you wonder. Now, see, that makes me wonder, are they discussing horse collar?
There are two fouls on the play, both against the defense. Personal foul, horse collar tackle. That penalty is declined. Personal foul, face mask, defense, number one. That penalty will be enforced 15 yards from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
That's a two-for-one. That means he horse-collared and he got the face mask. There's a left hand on the face mask. There's a right hand on the back of the jersey, which is a horse collar. My goodness, that's a first for me.
You don't hear that called at the same time. Never. On the same player.
Never seen it before.
I haven't either.
And the Marshall faithful wish they never saw it.
Marshall's up despite being down 2-0 in the turnover battle.
You just think, I mean, it's really hard to do those two fouls at the same time.
It is.
I mean, I'm almost impressed, but it's against the rules, so I can't be impressed, right?
You ever been called for maybe two in consecutive plays?
No.
That's delay of game. Disconcerting signals. Defense, number 18. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
And that is the second disconcerting call penalty on A.J. McGee today. Disconcerting signals called on A.J. McGee.
Well, that's a problem. And then, first of all, getting that penalty is a problem on first down. Now it's first and five. But then the Marshall beaters, unforced errors like pre-snap penalties. These are things that have stubbed Marshall in the toe during this five-game losing streak. You got to get rid of that right now.
They brought Hood in motion, going down the seam. This is where they've made their money tonight. Once again, it's Barden. They hit him deep. And they'll set up shop inside the 43 yards.
You want to see a perfect pass, Jason? Look at your screen. That is perfect, folks. Anything else would have been an incompletion. That's how you lay the ball out and allow your dynamic playmaker, one of them anyway, because they've got multiple guys, but Jalen Barden has continued to show up, and he's had a nice string of the last 3 or 4 weeks, but he's played really well.
They mark it down at the 5. Number one passing offense in the Sun Belt strikes again. And now they're knocking on the door of retaking the lead.
You just don't score enough points against these guys because they're going to keep coming.
That play appeared to be blown dead. May have been a timeout called before it was snapped.
Hey, that's on you guys.
Elijah Alston a bit shaken up there.
Timeout. Georgia Southern. Their first. 30-second timeout.
They did call a timeout. A play that won't count comes at the expense of Elijah Alston, who's down on the field for Marshall. Gets up on his own weight. What's been a physical game in the interior tonight. The catch again, Tioka. The seam routes in particular feel so hard to stop.
And so often you see quarterbacks under or overthrow these balls. But that one was perfect.
That's Brent's money ball.
It really is. And we talked about his superpower is his accuracy. Well, he's kind of got two of them because he gets the ball out on time most of the time. But his accuracy is generally really so stopping to watch when you watch the tape of the guy.
Trying to finish off this drive, of course, a field goal to take the lead too, but they're not thinking three. They're thinking six here in what's been a back-and-forth, entertaining late-season Sun Belt matchup. Standing implications on the line. Georgia Southern could still make the conference title. Marshall wants to make a bowl game and win it on an important night for them. Brynn lofts it up, incomplete.
Well, that was a very interesting formation and call. Man, you got big people in the game, three tight ends in the game, one running back. So that's 13 personnel with an extra offensive lineman. They tried to fake the toss and then hit one of the tight ends in the back, in the back of the end zone. And it's just great eye discipline by this Marshall defense. You're going to get tested in a lot of ways with this Georgia Southern offense. Man, they really make you be great with your eyes.
They bring in Josh Dallas. It's a decoy. And they get about a yard here.
Shovel pass. Those can be very successful because your aggressive defensive line getting up the field, and creating running seams inside, but not that time.
Third and goal. A big one. Fake it to White. Brynn, they'll come up short. The Marshall defense, it's Foster who got there initially. Stand tall and force what could be a field goal attempt coming up here.
Well, it was the same play they ran a couple plays ago, but this time they run it with a boot action, hoping that you bring in the back from all the way across the formation, he'd get lost in the wash. But again, with man coverage, if everybody does their job and stays with their guy, you're going to have a defender on every receiver. Once again, so like a broken record, but that's great coverage by the Marshall defense.
Lance from 21 for the lead. Third lead change of the game. Georgia Southern goes back in front in this third quarter. Inside of the final 2 minutes of this third. Georgia Southern coming off the loss to Texas State. Charles Hoffman Marshall hungry. I mean hungry for a win after they've lost five in a row, but they have simply not looked like a team that's lost five in a row. And on top of that, giving a redshirt freshman his first start tonight, Cole Pennington, in place of Cam Vancher. You told me before the game, maybe Marshall's weaknesses need to become their strengths. Well, offensively, explosive plays, something we certainly have not associated Marshall with over these last few weeks. They've hit that with Cole Pennington.
Well, we talk about a lot of boxing as it relates to football. Styles make fights. Well, same thing with football, styles. We know that just Georgia Southern defense isn't great against the run. We know the best thing Marshall does is run the football with Rasheed Ali. But what else does that do other than just be efficient with the run game? It creates play-action pass opportunities. That's what has been there for Marshall, the play-action pass and the slants against eight-man front.
Well, they haven't given Jaden Harrison opportunities to return since he had the 98-yard kickoff, so Sean Salas needed about the 38. They're going to have good field position here as you see the drive chart. Not including, of course, the 98-yard kickoff return on the opening kick of the game. Here's Cole Pennington trotting back out.
Because of the scoreboard, two-point game. Rasheed Ali has not been taken out of his ball game. Continue to lean on him, which sets the table for this offense.
Pennington dishes it to Keaton. Looks like he wants to throw. Now he does. Might have something. He does. McMillan. Receiver to receiver, they go on the trickery. The explosives continue.
And they're working on Shamar Bartholomew. He got a little nosy trying to come up to play run support.
Offense.
But it doesn't matter.
10-yard penalty. Remains first down.
So there are a lot of receivers involved, and ultimately it's a receiver tagged with holding there. Darryl Simmons, and it's going to bring back that gain.
Coach Huff calls them Marshall beaters. Penalties, turnovers, unforced errors. It's been the Achilles heel of this team for the last five straight weeks.
So we couldn't hear it. They called it on Chris Motillo, 86.
That's borderline. Usually the indicator is when the player goes down or you see his body torque. I didn't really see either of those, but I'm just going to lean on officials. He probably had a better look than me.
Now, different situation, a much different one. Georgia Southern trying to pick up where they left off momentum-wise. Tarion Lee made the tackle. There is a flag down over on that same sideline where the hit happened.
I look to be in the Eagles secondary.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense, number 20, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Marshall crowd erupts after the call on Seth Robertson, a guy who's had to step in due to some injuries on the back end.
Boy, that's a costly penalty because you had this offense reeling. So let's take a look and see what we can see on a replay. Look at the right side of your screen. Looking for number 20, Robertson. And there it is, clear as day.
Penalties continue to play a key role in this game. Marshall has 8 for 65 yards. Georgia Southern has 6 for 40 yards. Pennington going to the air. Dangerous pass. Shamar Bartholomew on the coverage came over to try to make the play. It was a little too high, though, for his leap that time.
Yeah, that was your young quarterback looking like a young quarterback there. I saw that coming a mile away. Tried to go play action, and that ball was lofted a little too high and a little too slow. He's expecting man coverage, and he's hoping Bartholomew gets influenced, but Bartholomew was on time. He saw the ball being thrown and made a break on it. Should have been 6 the other way.
Bartholomew blitzes this time, and they have the run sniffed out. Didn't matter. Rasheed Ali certainly looks healthy. That's a good game there.
Yeah, again, I'm running Ali until his tongue is dragging. I mean, that's your best option. Certainly mix in some screens and mix in some play action, but it's all going to start with that guy on the screen because he can score anytime he touches the ball.
Third and two for Pennington. They opt to throw. Dump it down the middle. Wanted McMillan. Broken up by Bartholomew.
Yeah, I don't like the decision there. Again, he throws in tight coverage, and that could have been a pick. Bartholomew's doing a great job of breaking on balls and being where he needs to be. Young quarterback got lucky there. I thought he had an opportunity, Jason, to try to run for that football on his own.
I think that'll come with the awareness of different situations and whatnot as he continues to get more experience, Cole Pennington. Meanwhile, fair catch made by Caleb Hood. 23 seconds to go in this third quarter, two-point game. Georgia Southern takes back over. Big defensive possession coming up for Marshall. Talk about the middle eight of the second quarter and third quarter. Now you're kind of thinking about it in this third quarter, fourth quarter.
Look, if you're Marshall, you're in position. I mean, it hasn't been perfect. At times, it's been less than what you wanted. But at the end of the day, you're staring at a two-point deficit at home going into the fourth quarter. This is where you wanted to take this game. Into the fourth quarter with the scoreboard looking right so you can continue to run the football offensively.
Charles Huff's mentality was give yourself an opportunity. They've definitely done that today. Jalen White hit pretty quickly there. Clay Helton for Georgia Southern said it's a must-win game. They'll hold the fours up pretty soon. Marshall has won five straight in the series between these two teams. But they've lost five straight in this regular season, trying to snap that losing streak. What an entertaining game it's been. Back and forth, three lead changes, two ties, two-point game heading to the fourth. Two-point game heading to the fourth quarter. Saturday night on NFL Network, Georgia Southern and Marshall know this is a big game and they're playing like it's a big game. The Georgia Southern team enters the fourth with the lead and the football. And an opportunity here for Dalen Cobb. Trying to break through some traffic with blocks. Foster fought off a block to ultimately take him down. Third and two on the horizon here.
It's a critical drive to me for this Marshall defense. You cannot allow this ball to matriculate down the field and end up in a touchdown, making the game a two-score game. You just can't afford it. So right now, defensively, you need to get off the field and set your offense up with really good field position.
Marshall third down defense has been very good today. Georgia Southern's just 3-for-12 on third down right now. Charles Huff in the Marshall sideline didn't like what they saw there.
Timeout. Marshall, they're first.
Burn a timeout.
30-second timeout.
You see Georgia Southern just has one left. That could be potentially something that plays an interesting role in this game.
I just think it was smart right there to call a timeout because he recognizes, talking about Huff, that this is a moment. This is a moment, a critical moment in this ball game. You cannot let this offense off the hook.
Want more NFL action this season? NFL Plus brings you live games on mobile, NFL Red Zone, NFL Network, game replays, and more all in one place. Sign up today at plus.nfl.com. Terms and conditions apply.
Let's go, Herd! Go, Herd!
Don't forget Colts, Patriots tomorrow morning on NFL Network and streaming on NFL Plus from Frankfurt. Meanwhile, we got ourselves a good one to wrap up our Saturday night.
Really do. I mean, this has been a tremendous ball game. Obviously, the atmosphere has lived up. The players are doing their part. Just a joy to call this game.
Third and two coming up. Bren rolled the way that Hood shifted out, but he was covered downfield, and Marshall's defense comes up with yet another big third down stop. Georgia Southern now just 3 of 13 on third down.
So I give credit to Jason Seymour. He went from being a man coverage team to a zone team critically. And you see Bren, he was expecting man. He's expecting that guy on that zoom motion to be wide open, outrunning a man-to-man cover guy, but it was zone. And so he ran right into a zone, nowhere to throw the football, and the rush comes home again.
Talik Keaton back to return here. And Marshall may have just flipped the field position in their favor for a young quarterback. It's a line drive punt, and Keaton fair catches it.
Situational football. We talked about that being a critical moment in this fourth quarter. The defense does its job. Now, offensively, you have to step up and do your job. Changing the scoreboard is the goal. Doesn't have to necessarily be a touchdown. You obviously take it, but you want to take the lead in this situation. So, complimentary football opportunity here for Marshall. And if you're Georgia Southern, you need to step up and make a play defensively, forcing a three and out.
Cole Pennington's first start of the season has been a good one. This offense has compiled 264 yards today. That one dangerously flicks off the hands of the intended target, DeMarcus Harris. Pennington 12 of 16 through the air now. They've kind of just had him do what he needs to do. Remember, he threw an interception on his very first pass of the game. That could affect a lot of people mentally. He's bounced back from that nicely. Dart of a throw here. What a Keaton, who went up. Did he haul it in, complete the process? It looks like he did.
He came down awkwardly. As you see, he's sort of laboring to get up. I saw two hands on that football. I thought this was going to be a completed catch. First of all, the ball's out a little bit late, so he has to wait for him. Boy, he took a shot. And Jason, look, I'm not sure. That looks like a completion to me. He has control of that football when his knee hits the ground. This ball gets snapped. It's a moot point. But, man, I thought he had control of the ball. The knee goes down. That play is dead as soon as the knee hit.
It's interesting. The control of the ball part could be a question mark.
Sure it is.
Instead, third and 10. Pressure got there immediately. Rasheen Ali got 6 yards. Definitely not enough for a first down. Feels like you're in territory to punt. Georgia Southern makes a nice stand there on defense.
Again, here's the call that was, well, here's the quick flare pass there. Get a block, and you're hoping that your back and make a man miss or two on the edge. But, man, I thought that incomplete pass, Jason, was at least worthy of the officials taking a look.
Oh, picking this up off the bounce is Hood.
Dangerous.
Walking the line in a tight game. Two-point game. Early stages, fourth quarter. Georgia Southern offense next.
If you drive a personal car for work and don't keep track of...
Welcome back to NFL Network. Tioka Jackson, Jason Ross Jr. bringing you back to Huntington on this Saturday night. Two-point game. Going to want to stick around for this fourth quarter. Georgia Southern up, and Davis Bren takes back over. The 60-year QB, who's made such an impression on this Georgia Southern program, having a magical year that they're trying to continue. Owen Porter exploded up the interior and made a big hit.
Jason Ross Jr., boy, I tell you, one-gap defenses are so fun to play in because you can take off up front and go ahead and grab the handoff, why don't you, Porter? My goodness, exploded off the edge. You want to get me excited? Give me some defensive linemen that love getting in the backfield. Porter's one of the better ones.
Huntington native. Grew up understanding the importance of the program to this community. Huge play.
Listen to this crowd.
Bren to throw. Bren
it.
Able to find a target on the sideline in Jalen Barden, the transfer from Pitt, to get a ton of that yardage back. Brings up 3rd and 4. Georgia Southern 3 of 13 on this down today.
Wow. And that's why the scoreboard is so tight. That's one of the reasons.
Yep.
But that's, man, this offense, that's what makes it so explosive. You don't have to get out of character to pick up 2nd and long. Now you're in 3rd and manageable. And don't be afraid to run it, Mr. Brin.
Looks like there might be a timeout.
Timeout. Marshall, their 2nd. 30-second timeout.
Both sides are burning them, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah. That's going to be an interesting point to make in a one-possession game down the stretch here. Georgia Southern's got 2 Marshall downages, 1 left, trailing by 2. But, of course, you feel this is a very important moment. You want to get it right.
Just like the last series, they burned a timeout on 3rd down. You'd rather not, but these are crucial moments. And one of the reasons why the game is still this tight is because you've been so good on defense on 3rd down. So if you feel like you miss a line or don't know what you're doing, go ahead and burn it. That's a valuable burn, sure, but it's worth it if you can get off the field on 3rd down. But look at Porter. That's a meeting at the football by multiple guys.
You ever seen someone tackle 2 guys at the same time?
Not in college. In high school, I did it.
There's 1 on each arm here.
He doesn't know because he doesn't know where the ball's going. But you know what?
We're
take them
down.
Both. You don't have to worry about it.
3rd and 4. Porter came with pressure. Brin steps up, tried to dump it off. There's another 3rd down stop for the Marshall defense. That has been the most important down of the day for the Thundering Herds. Now give their offense another chance here.
I just like the way Jason Seymour is changing up this coverage. This is a man coverage defense, but he's going to a lot of zone. And it's confusing this offense. And when you got a rush as ferocious as theirs, there's just not going to be enough time for the quarterback to go through his progressions. Brin couldn't set his feet. Ball on the ground. Georgia Southern's punting.
Who can be the better team in this 4th quarter? Clay Helton has said in losses, we haven't been as good in the 2nd half, and we've addressed that as a staff. Both teams were good in the 3rd quarter. Who's going to own the 4th, though, tonight? That'll be the question mark. This is going to be a fun one down the stretch here.
Thursday Night Football on Prime. It's on.
Pennington making the start tonight in place of Cam Fancher has looked very poised. His dad was pretty poised back in the day as well. Chad Pennington played at Marshall from 95 to 99. See the 99 Heisman Trophy finalist, a legend around here. Inducted into the Marshall Athletics Hall of Fame in 2010. Years in the NFL, double digits, 11 total, Jets and Dolphins. His son has done an excellent job today. Rasheen Ali has a hole.
Gone.
Broke it. Rasheen Ali. Marshall in front in the blink of an eye. 55 yards.
Charles Huff made a point to tell us we've got to be able to get into the 4th quarter in a way that Rasheen Ali can still be an option for our offense. You just saw why. Every time he touches it, it's a threat to go the distance.
Just like that, the Thundering Herd retake the lead. And it's a 5-point advantage. They had scored single digits in points each of the last 3 weeks. They've put up 31 today with still practically an entire quarter to go.
Driscoll, Holler, Osborne, Slappy, and Tucker, the big guys up front, you did your job because that is basically an untouched back going through the hole, through the secondary, and through the end zone. And
every running back should be this lucky to see cutback lanes like that. And then when you're this talented, man, that's all you need. Special player, Jason.
He's healthy now. Was banged up the last couple of weeks.
And I love the wildcat option. We didn't see a lot of that earlier in the year because he wasn't, like you said, wasn't 100%. And him being 100% on the field, it creates a bigger playbook opportunity for this offense.
He's over the century mark. Like you said, another dimension to an offense that defenses have had a relatively easy time stopping the last few weeks because they've been limited both injury-wise, just what they can do because of the lack of personnel. Now they're getting healthy at the right time like they did last year at this time.
And one of the low-key bonuses about having number 22 Ali in your lineup is it creates throwing opportunities. All the throwing lanes were so much tighter, so much congestion in the secondary because no one had to respect the run game with him being out in less than 100%. Now that he's back in a big way, the defense has to adjust and add extra people to the box that's allowed this pass game to be efficient enough to have some balance.
All right. It's been a night of how can you respond to the punch you just took.
PAT sucks. And so, excuse me, but yeah, so, I mean, look, you can't celebrate but too much because, look, it's still a one-score game. A touchdown, you're losing if you're Marshall. And if you're Georgia Southern, you're fine.
Jalen White carrying tacklers ahead.
I love the discipline of staying with the run game if you're Georgia Southern. We talked about this offense is based on the RPO game. They're counting the box on every single play. They're taking a look at how many people you're committing to the box. And right now looks to be six and a half. I can run into this look if you're Georgia Southern.
Marshall started to get some pressure on that last drive. Porter got in the face of Brin. Able to find Hood there. But it looks like they are going to move the chains here. Got enough.
Yeah, he went out and got it.
Yeah.
I've seen him do that multiple times on tape. And that's why I was surprised earlier he didn't go down and get that other low pass that we saw from Brin, because he is just really special at going down and digging out plays. But Brin showed some toughness right there. You gotta have some real onions to stand in with a rush like that and throw a ball, catchable ball. Nice job by Brin.
Georgia Southern's lost five straight to Marshall. Jalen White gets gobbled up. Slew of hurt defenders. Kerryon Martin, Charleston, West Virginia native, a junior here, made the tackle.
Well, I thought that was an error by White. He tried to bounce that. You go up inside. You've got a lane up inside. Go ahead and take the three or four. He tries to bounce it. And there's a defender there doing his job of setting the edge, and that's Martin. Nice job, Martin, by keeping your arm outside arm free and making the play.
To White that time, brings up third down. This has been the story of the game for the Marshall defense. Georgia Southern just 3 of 14 today on third down.
So if you're Marshall, can you get lined up and be ready to play without calling timeout? And if you're Georgia Southern, what do you turn to? Protection's got to be there. When Brent has time, he's been effective. It's the pass rush that's made him ineffective.
Brin wants one of those windows again. Incomplete. 3 of 15 on third down. Intentions for Barden. Couldn't hang on. This will likely be the punting unit coming up.
Just a little bit off. Just a little bit off on the accuracy from Brennan. You haven't said that a lot tonight. That ball came out on time. Just a little bit off, and Brin tried to go down and dig it. Couldn't get it done. Big stop by this Marshall defense.
This Marshall team collectively visited the cemetery last night, earlier this week. met with Coach Huff and reinforced how important this night is, honoring the 75 lives that were lost in the plane crash, and how important it is to play with that emotion on your shoulder. They played with a ton of emotion tonight, trying to snap a five-game losing streak. They're up five, 8-12 to go. The memorial fountain, a visible reminder of the 75 lives lost in the 1970 plane crash. More than 13 feet high, weighing 6,500 pounds. A symbol of community here in Huntington, West Virginia. Charles Huff reiterated to us how important this night is on and off the field, wearing the black uniforms. The fans wearing black tonight as well. A hole opened up for Ashin Ali on their last possession that went 55 yards to take the lead. 8 minutes to go. Marshall with one timeout. Georgia Southern with two. A critical, critical game for Georgia Southern in the standings on the East Division side to try to keep their conference title hopes alive. Coming off the loss last week to Texas State. Marshall's lost five in a row, but haven't looked like a team that's lost five in a row. There's Clay Helton. Georgia Southern fan base has really gravitated towards what he's brought to the table, and rightfully so, has done a spectacular job. Another jump cut from Ali. Georgia Southern having trouble stopping this, Tioka. Why is that?
Well, first of all, the offensive line is getting a hat on a hat. And when you have a back this dynamic, you don't have to hold your blocks for long, because 22, Ali has great vision and quickness and explosion. So he's going to find it and get through. He doesn't have to be a house call on every play, although he's up to the task, but he's getting through the line of scrimmage and moving the chains efficiently. This is a welcome addition to this offense. Hasn't been like this all year.
He missed most of last year, got the medical redshirt. Ball came out! Ball came out!
Wow.
Looked like Pennington pounced on it, though. Marshall nearly had their third turnover of the night. And remember, that's the magic number for Georgia Southern.
Absolutely right. Look at right there. That was great job attacking. Yeah, great job attacking the ball by Bartholomew.
I mean, he knocked it out cleanly.
And how many times have you seen balls like this get recovered by the defense? I mean, look at this. Oh, so close.
Watson Trent was inches away from potentially setting up Georgia Southern at the Marshall 25. Screen set up here. Brian Robinson, first time he's gotten involved tonight.
I'm seeing a young Cole Pennington get comfortable. We're seeing a young guy grow up before our eyes. You talked about the early turnover. A quarterback that lacks mental toughness, he would have never been able to shake that off. I'm seeing Pennington turn the page early on and get more and more comfortable, get more and more confident, and this coaching staff is allowing him to throw the football on early downs, which I think is smart.
Pennington hands it off. Another hole for Ashin Ali, reaching Georgia Southern territory.
Well, look, you didn't think they were going to go away from this hot rod, did you? I know he put it on the ground, but watch the jump cuts. Right here. Forget about it. If you are one-on-one against Ali, you're in trouble. Because, especially if he has a two-way go. The first guy rarely tackles him. That is a tremendous trait to have if you're a running back.
Hasn't really left the game much. Doesn't even look like he's broken a sweat today doing it. Marquez Watson-Trent made his 100th tackle of the season on that play. But Marshall is the team that's knocking on the door. Field goal range now. Ethan Payne, the other back, gets dragged down by Justin Rhodes. A big tackle by Rhodes with 4:30 to go in the game. Clock ticking now. Georgia Southern again with two timeouts.
If you're a Marshall fan, you're like, why are we handing it to anyone else? Well, listen, we can't run 22 until he collapses. We got to be able to do something else against or with this run game. I get it. But, man, it seems like when anyone else other than Ali tries to run the football, there's nothing doing.
It was a big loss of seven there. That drags it certainly out of field goal range here. So the Georgia Southern defense trying to buckle down and keep it a five-point game. Big tackle from Rhodes.
If you're the Eagle defense, you've got to capitalize on that TFL.
Rasheen Ali bottled up in the interior. Defensive coordinator Brandon Bailey for Georgia Southern, who is a Georgia Southern alum living out his dream. He wants his defense to dial something up here on 3rd and 15. He told Justin Rhodes last week, you're a warrior.
Timeout.
Now
Georgia
this defense
Southern,
trying to take a collective.
30-second timeout. Please reset the game clock to 3 minutes and 45 seconds. 3 minutes and 45 seconds.
Trying to take a collective warrior mentality with 3:42 to go in the fourth quarter. Well, don't forget, next week, more Saturday Night Football on NFL Network. Louisiana heads to Troy to take on the Trojans, a Troy team that's currently at the top of the West Division right now. It's an earlier start time next week, 3:30 p.m. Eastern time, only on NFL Network and streaming on NFL Plus. That'll be next week at Troy. Chris Lewis has been phenomenal. Gunnar Watson, the QB at Troy, potentially on track to make it to another conference title game.
Look at those numbers. 24.3 a catch. Are you kidding me? Wow.
That was a Georgia Southern timeout, by the way. So each team down to one left.
So Georgia Southern's got a three-man line. They're going to break coverage, which I think is smart. Force this young quarterback to have to read it out. And you better be very careful if you're Cole Pennington. There's no need to try to play hero ball here. You're ahead on the scoreboard by five. You've got an opportunity to punt this football if you can't get the first and pin him down inside the 10.
Pennington will throw. Screen set up. Reversing Fields here and getting a few yards.
Just Caleb
Combs. Did the ball come out toward the tail end there? Georgia Southern thinks they have it. It did come out earlier in the drive. And for the second time on the drive, Marshall recovers, specifically Cole Pennington.
The Thunder and Herd are living right. I'm just telling you right now, the football gods have blessed him twice on this drive. Let's take a look at it. Tuck that ball away. Oh, yeah, that's out.
Wow.
I mean, that is just a tremendous job by
Deshaun Davis
of getting that football out. And unfortunately,
Georgia Southern, their third and final timeout of the game.
Davis forced a fumble earlier in the game, by the way.
Yeah.
That was recovered by Isaac Walker. And he nearly did it for the second time.
That's right. Between he and Walker, I mean, they are just tremendous at attacking the football and getting the ball out. And usually they recover them. Unfortunately for them, they haven't been able to recover every single fumble today.
Up at the top of the conference in forced turnovers this season. Two clean strips of Marshall players and couldn't recover either one. They are going to get the football back, though.
And you've made a point multiple times that when they get three turnovers, they don't lose. So they're sitting at two, right?
Nearly got the third twice.
So the game is teetering on these potential turnovers, and they're not getting them.
Caleb Hood back to return the punt. And it took a Marshall bounce to settle down. It just died at the two. What a punt there of 42 yards. An excellent one from John McConnell. Davis Brin trying to play the hero role when we return.
The holiday already changed the world.
So here comes the 60-year QB Davis Brin and Georgia Southern taking back over on offense, trying to keep their hopes of making a conference title game alive after Coastal Carolina won earlier today. They'll have to go 98 yards. It's their worst starting field position of the day at the most important time of the day. Brin just has to escape out of the end zone. Not known for his legs, got some back there improvising. No timeouts for Georgia Southern, one for Marshall.
Smart. I mean, every quarterback has a clock in his head. The clock told him, leave the pocket and get what you can get.
This offense can strike in a hurry, going to the receiver on the boundary there. Intentions that time for Derwin Burgess. 3rd and 4 coming up.
The pressure got in the quarterback's face, got a hit on the quarterback. He couldn't step into the throw, and therefore it was short and into the ground.
4 down territory for Georgia Southern. in the loudest part of the stadium right now.
Well, he expected Burgess to keep coming and drifting towards the middle. Watch Burgess sit down. This is man coverage. Burgess needs to keep coming. He sat down. You got two guys not on the same page. Easily could have been a pick. Fourth down, the ball game's right here, Jason.
Game comes down to this. Conference title hopes might come down to this. White in motion. Brin steps up, throws, incomplete, broken up. Marshall gets a huge stop.
And the official's down.
We have an official down on a collision across the middle.
And he took a shot from behind, I'm telling you right now.
Staffs from both sides immediately come out.
Boy, I'm glad he's getting up, Jason.
That's our umpire, Vaughn Cohen. There was a lot going on over the middle on that route.
No doubt, including the umpire. The pre-snap motion tells Brin it's man coverage. So now he just has to get this ball out on time and allow his receiver to get open. Well, he's not. And unfortunately for Georgia Southern, one of the defenders was the umpire. And that's not the umpire's fault. He's a part of the field. You got to find a way to throw that ball around him, not through him. But either way, the receiver was double covered. That's just tremendous defense by Marshall on a day where they continue to answer the call defensively.
Good to see Vaughn pop back up. And he's back in play now. So 2:47 to go. Georgia Southern has no timeouts. If you're Marshall here, you, of course, could end it with a touchdown. Derek snap here to Ali. Have to be careful. Rasheen Ali going to waltz in, and that should put the icing on the cake. What are you thinking time-wise?
Well,
of course,
first of all, the way defensively Georgia Southern look, I'm wondering, did they allow him to score thinking it'd be better? I mean, look at 67 right there. Excuse me, 57. That's the Trail Bullard. I mean, you tell me. I mean, I think that's one of those situations where the staff, the coaching staff, told their defense the best chance we have is allow them to score quick, get the ball back. We score quick because we are an air raid offense. Then go onside kick, hopefully get the ball back and score quick again and win the game.
With no timeouts, that feels like the route to go.
Yeah, I mean, as much as you hate to see it, that's probably the most cerebral way to manage that situation. Ali doesn't care. That's a cheap touchdown for him. He'll take it.
Georgia Southern, you see in the standings after Coastal Carolina wins today. App State 4-2 in conference play as well. James Madison ineligible for the conference championship. Troy in command in the West, but still multiple teams in the mix there in the East. But this would be a big blow for Georgia Southern's hopes if they don't get two touchdowns here in the final 2 minutes and change.
Yeah, we talked about a couple weeks ago a game being an eliminator game. Well, this is an eliminator game for Georgia Southern if they lost. Marshall probably, you know, not probably, they don't have a chance to win the East. They have a chance at bowl eligibility. But Georgia Southern had all their hopes and dreams still ahead of them. And look, it's not over yet. 2:41. There's been a lot of crazy things in college football over the years. You'd be extremely foolish to pick up your clicker now.
So this return feels important here. And Dalen Cobb will get it out, get out of bounds for Clay Helton's team. Like you said, they need two quick scores. Davis Brin comes back out, 2:36 to go. Troy, by the way, has clinched in the West. So they have their spot back in the conference title game again this year.
So the bad news is Georgia Southern's down 12 with 2:36 to go. The good news is you run the air raid, and you've got Davis Brennan. You've got one of the best passing offenses in America. So you're just running your base stuff. You've got to score quickly, though, with no timeouts left. And then we'll try an onside kick and see what happens.
Brennan going to be hit by Owen Porter here, who never gives up on the play. Guy who spoke to his team about this matchup earlier this week was fired up for it.
The ability to generate a pass rush with four guys is invaluable for any defense.
Vertical threats again behind the intended target, Cobb.
Once again, though, the mixing of man coverage and zone coverage has really been a tremendous story in this game. There's been some confusion on Davis Brennan's part because sometimes he's looking for man beater routes when it's zone coverage, and that's very scary. Surprised there haven't been more picks. Or any picks.
Remember, Georgia Southern's up 2-0 in the turnover battle in this game. Nearly forced a fumble on the last Marshall drive prior to that one. But does that turn around here? In on the coverage was Deonte Hill. Going up against Derwin Burgess, he almost jumped that route.
Almost had his second INT of the season. That would have ended the game for sure, I believe. Here's the ball game, partner.
Any last gasp is here. Brennan pressured by Porter. Brennan looking for Jalen Barden. Did he hang on? What a grab at the 40. They pick up 20 yards.
Barden's had a great day, and he had a defender draped all over him. Still made the catch.
Georgia Southern says we're not done quite yet. No timeouts to work with. Another quick throw. Derwin Burgess this time. Clock will move here after that completion. Not a first down. Gain of about six. Now Marshall calls their final timeout.
I think this is just to give the defenders a breather.
Marshall. That's their third timeout of the game.
Again, a Marshall team, single digits in points each of the last 3 weeks. 9 points a week ago in a disappointing rivalry performance at App State. Come back and they put 38 points up on the board. Without their starting quarterback today, Cole Pennington steps in, who did take most of the reps in practice this week. And they have come out and looked like a different team.
They really have. And it started with the kick return. We talked about the energy. The energy was right on time. But more importantly, again, I mentioned the execution. The execution is everlasting, and it's been really solid execution the entire game, and that's why they're in the position that they're in against a very good football team. Marshall was the underdog, the prohibitive underdog coming into this game. But this is college football. You've got to bring your A game in conference late in the season every single week.
Trying to get bowl eligible for this seventh straight year. They'll need another win to do that. Right now, trying to finish things up here. An incompletion and then some extracurricular activity as Moten went down after a shove.
Well, I'm shocked the flag didn't come. Dalen Cobb, a two-hand push to the face of the defender.
Emotions high. An emotional night. Here in Huntington, 93 seconds to go. Third and four for Brennan. And he goes down the seam, nearly slipping a tackle for what would have been a touchdown was Dalen Cobb. But they'll have to reset. Clock will stop on that first down inside of 2 minutes to go. Now they reset it, so it'll start again.
What a play by Josh Moten to save the touchdown.
Brin. Once Burgess, oh, that was nearly intercepted by Deonte Hill.
Deonte Hill's got to catch the football is what he's thinking. I got two hands on that ball.
That would have iced it.
You can't give extra lives to this offense. They're too good. You got to catch the football. My goodness.
Another incompletion, high for Barden that time. Georgia Southern needs some magic. It's been a magical season, but 1:13 to go. Chances diminishing by the second here. Coastal Carolina fans tuning in. They're Marshall fans right now. After their win earlier today in the Sun Belt. Just a couple of chances left, and another high throw. A flag in the backfield, though. Brin went down.
Last couple throws, just a little bit inaccurate from Brin. You don't see that very often. That was a shot at a touchdown.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, number 99, half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
They got Gibson.
That's a hit. See, that's hit. Yeah, yep, I mean, that's just a bad, come on. I mean, that's not smart football right there. I mean, you're down to one play from the game being potentially over. You take a shot that late, makes no sense. That's a Marshall beater. First down, Georgia Southern.
Fresh set of downs, first and goal now for Georgia Southern. And up the middle goes White. Broke one tackle, a touchdown saving tackle on the back end.
I'd get up to the line of scrimmage and run it again, but that would be risky. But I'm running this ball again.
Brin clocks it. No timeouts, 54 seconds to go.
So they decide to give up the down and clock in the football. So now it's third down, though, Jason. So now you got only two plays left. But, of course, you only need 2 yards. Question is, do you have the gall to run it again? And if you don't, how do you manufacture a touchdown? Wouldn't be shocked if they get Brin on the move here.
They want the one-on-one. Burgess, touchdown. Georgia Southern still fighting with under a minute to go.
Well, Brin's been less than perfect this drive, but when they needed him to have it, he throws a great fade ball. And one guy went up, and that's your receiver. The coverage was not bad by Bartholomew, but you got to go make a play on the ball. Watch Burgess go with two hands. Inbounds. How often do you see quarterbacks throw their receiver out of bounds? Terrific job of throwing a fade route by Brin.
Now Lance will make it a 5-point game with this extra point. Then you go for the onside. Davis Brin will be waiting to see what that onside kick result is. Seconds to go. Brin finds Burgess and makes it a one possession game.
From a statistic standpoint, this is not the most efficient way to score touchdowns. You don't get a lot of success throwing the fade, especially against bump and run, where they can get the route off schedule and screw up the timing. But that's a great release there, and that's a great job also of going up and getting the football and not allowing the defender to make a play on it.
Georgia Southern program just a couple of years removed from a three-win season. Building up under Clay Helton. They enter today looking for win number 7 on the season. This will be their first onside kick attempt of the season.
This is a phase that gets practiced every week, towards the end of every week. Both sides practice this. Let's see who can execute it under tight circumstances.
Took a hop and out of bounds. There's the flag. Charles Huff is fired up on the sideline for his team that began
free
this
kick out
night.
Of bounds on the kicking team, 5-yard penalty, first down.
His team began this night with a 98-yard kickoff return and a special teams play that set the stage, and they end the night by executing on the onside kick attempt.
Well, you took the words right out of my mouth. Special teams got the day started. Special teams seals the deal.
They can seal the deal in victory formation. You could see in those shots how much this game meant to Charles Huff, how much it means to the community, how much it means to this program. Honoring the 75 lives that were lost in 1970 in the plane crash, a group that had lost 5 in a row after a 4-0 start. They had a dream start to the game with a 98-yard kickoff return. And now they can dream of celebrating tonight, because they will be.
Come on, Jameson!
Cole Pennington. Drawn into the duty of starting quarterback tonight. Son of Chad Pennington, the Marshall great. He was excellent. He was certainly excellent today. What a win for Marshall.
But when you got a 75 situation where you're playing homage, you don't know who's going to win or lose, but what you want to do is honor those fallen souls by the way you play. And so I tip my cap to everybody in the black jersey and all the coaching staff, because they were prepared to play, and they played hard, and they executed high. They won the game, yes, but it's the way they play that you could be proud of if you're a Marshall fan.
Saturday night did not disappoint on NFL Network today. Marshall upsets Georgia Southern at home on an emotional night. For Tyoka Jackson, our outstanding crew, producer Jeff Graham, director Kevin Shank, everyone in the truck, you guys do a phenomenal job every week. I'm Jason Ross Jr. saying so long.